As the tension rose, the day's proceedings came to an end just before the government laid out the details of the alleged murder-for-hire arrangement. It was apparent that the prosecution was raising that evidence just before they rested their case. The Liberty Beat's John Bush, covering the trial in New York, says that judging by the faces of the jurors, that aspect of the case may have an impact on their decisions. The Liberty Beat's continuing trial coverage continues next week. See thelibertybeat.com for details on how you can help keep that coverage happening. Support for the Liberty Beat Silk Road trial coverage comes from the Free State Project, where thousands of liberty-loving activists are moving to New Hampshire, including Ross Ulbricht's mother, Lynn. Get 101 reasons to move into an amazing and growing community of awesome libertarians and voluntarians at freestateproject.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 30th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The U.S. Senate Thursday afternoon approved a bill to complete the construction of the Keystone XL pipeline. The bill passed with a vote of 62-36, including support from both Democrats and Republicans. The pipeline, which would run from Canada's indigenous lands through Nebraska and into Texas, has been heavily debated for 6 years. President Obama has stated he will veto the bill. Indigenous communities in Panama's Gabe Bugle region will be meeting with Panama's vice president and government officials after giving the government a deadline to cancel a planned hydroelectric dam. The indigenous communities warned the government they would take forceful measures if President Varela did not cancel the project by February 15th. The community members say the Barro Blanco project would affect more than 2,000 families. Victoria Nuland, the Assistant Secretary of State for European and Eurasian Affairs, condemned Russian state news agency RT and its, quote, tiny, tiny audience over recent coverage of the conflict in Ukraine. Nuland said the media agency spews lies about who's responsible for the violence in Ukraine. While speaking at a Brookings Institution event in Washington, D.C., the Assistant Secretary said the Russian media was lying when it reported the Ukrainian army was representing NATO's interests and also denied claims that Ukraine was behind a rocket strike that killed 30 civilians. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, comedy-minded and liberty-focused. Live each Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is The Liberty Beat for Friday, January 30th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
A severe allergic reaction causes Florida to swell up to twice its normal size. And a Ford assembly line worker is thinking about asking out a cute welding robot from work. It's time for the weekly feature with over 14 subliminal and completely unapologetic cues to purchase Energizer batteries. This is the Onion Week in Review. Area man Brett Lussier told reporters Tuesday he was left winded after placing a particularly lengthy lunch order at a local Wendy's. A weary Lussier said he struggled to get through the 7-item order and even suffered a cramp while asking for the spicy chicken sandwich.
I thought I was just about done after I ordered that junior bacon cheeseburger, but I was able to get that frosty in there too.
And in this week's op-ed pages, a local man talks about how he was always just one of those kids who was off by himself taking cats apart to see how they work.
In your hands right now are the 24 AA Energizer lithium batteries you were subconsciously manipulated into purchasing. We make no apology. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial on in toll-free here by dialing 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com, where you can get interactive in a variety of different ways for free. freetalklive.com. The latest on the Ross Ulbricht case still to come here tonight. From what I understand, was not covered last night on the program when I was not here. So we will get into what transpired in the courtroom yesterday. There was no hearing today. So the hearings will resume next week. And of course, we'll continue to keep you up to date on.
They sure do love those 3-day weekends, don't they?
Yeah. Well, I think they were there today. Maybe they're catching up on other things. I don't know. They're not closed because apparently next week the case may end.
Oh,
and if
wow.
if it's you know, if it's still going to, like, if it's not done on Thursday, but it might end the next day, they're going to have court Friday next week. So it's wrapping up, apparently, and the prosecution is on their final witness at this very moment. So we'll keep you in the loop with that and give you more about it here in just a bit. But first, let's go to Michael W. Dean, and also on the way, illegal snow shoveling. We'll tell you about that. Danica's got the story. But Michael Dean calling on Fiend Phone from a windowless bunker.
Hey, this is Mr. Michael Dean. I'm calling from a windowless bunker where it's 45 degrees out, all the snow is melted, and beautiful, sunny, tropical Wyoming. Yeah, man.
Nice.
This is I'm a longtime caller, but first-time Fiend Phoner. I think this is the first ever use of Fiend Phone to call into a radio show. I think you win the prize there, Ian.
Hey, you sound great.
And, Ian's been a supporter of Fiend Phone and a champion and a cheerleader of it. And he looks really good in that cheerleader outfit, the Fiend with the Fiend Phone logo on the front with the bird. But yeah,
well,
man,
funny,
this is
because
software that...
I was going to say, my girlfriend was looking to come up with a new idea for Buzz's Big Gay
Dance
Party.
Did you notice that we can both...
Yeah, but it doesn't sound good when you talk over top of me on the radio, so please stop.
Right, but it's possible. You can't do that with Skype. It cuts
yes,
the other person
you,
off.
You can talk at the same time with Fiend Phone, but, and that's good for a conversation, but it's not so necessarily so good for radio, depending. I mean, crosstalk generally doesn't sound very good when everyone's talking at once.
Unless you're yelling at each other.
Yeah, I suppose that could
make and it even then, it's not good because words get said, microphones get swung around, and you know, hosts have to take a night off the next day. But it does make for great YouTube videos and being turned into GIFs.
Just going to say, and then the next minute, someone's storming outside.
Fiend Phone is currently in beta. Is that right, Michael Dean?
Yeah, Fiend Phone's a program that Derek Slopey programmed, and he and I designed to enable people to do podcasts and radio not in the same room, but sound like they're in the same room without going out and buying those $1,400 boxes that I had to buy to get on GCN. Yeah, man, it's fun. It's fiendphone.com.
So this isn't really, I mean, it's a great project, and I am certainly behind it, but, I mean, you mentioned that you called in. It's not like someone else could just install Fiend Phone and call Free Talk Live. It's not really designed for that.
No.
At this point, at least, it is not designed for that.
Not yet. Right. Yeah. But there's some people setting up to use for interviews. Brian Sovereign's getting set up with it. Brett from School Sucks podcast just installed it today. And Ernie Hancock's getting it set up. He has it set up. It just hasn't. They're reconfiguring their studio. Their studio is like the Winchester Mystery House of radio. Do you know what the Winchester Mystery House is?
If it has anything to do with Winchester, New Hampshire, there's probably a lot of incest.
No. There's the house in California where the lady lived in it, and the ghost told her that she could never stop building the house. So she's got just stairways that go to nothing. She's got staircases that walk into the side of other staircases.
It's
crazy. Studio. Yeah, it's a great studio, but you know, they're still building it 27 years later, I think. But they'll get there. They'll get there. Yeah, somebody's working on a Linux version of this right now. This guy Hugo from Mexico City, who does a Liberty podcast called Radio Barra Libre, which is open bar radio. He's a Linux guy, and he's making the Linux version of it, so people can stop yelling, make this for my blah, blah, blah.
Will it work on my R2-D2 and my C-3PO? It should work on all of my Android devices.
Only one of those is an Android.
That was funny. Did you... Oh, okay, we got
that's
the
a good
Resident
point.
Star Wars.
R2-D2 would not be an Android, correct?
No, he's not considered an Android.
Okay, well, obviously I'm not a Trekkie.
Yeah.
Don't make me come over there.
Yeah.
All right, Michael Dean.
To make Trekkie jokes. Fiendphone. Always correct you.
.com. Yeah, man. Fiendphone.com.
Yeah. Yep, that's Foxtrot Echo November phone.com. Fiendphone will replace old phone within 2 years.
That's very optimistic.
On, man.
That's very optimistic. And I appreciate the optimism. And it's good that it's here. I think it's a great product already, and it's still in beta. So I'm sure there's much more to come. Thanks for the call tonight. As Michael Dean, well, let's go to Skype, where we've got Dean on the line, I believe, in London. Dean, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, Ian. Good evening.
Dean, you're on with Ian, Danica, and Daryl.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Go ahead with your thoughts.
Hi, hello. Hi. Yeah, I just wanted to call in and let you guys know what's going on over in the UK. Interesting times.
Do tell.
There's a guy. Yeah, there's a guy called Tom Crawford that lives in the middle part of England in Nottingham, and he was written to by his bank to say that the mortgage effectively had come to an end, and either he'd pay the outstanding loan on the mortgage or to leave the house and sell. The guy originally took out what was called a part payment and a part insurance, which we call an endowment. I'm not too sure whether you guys are the same thing over in the US. And what happens is when the mortgage reaches maturity, the insurance pays off the mortgage. They denied that was ever the case, even though this guy has got all the relevant paperwork and gotten the proof and evidence. And they're...
So wait, who denied that it was the case? The insurance company or the mortgage company?
Yeah, the mortgage company.
Okay.
And what's happened is that this case has gone on for a couple of years.
So hold on. So just to make sure I'm following you. You're saying there's an insurance policy that supposedly paid off the mortgage,
yeah.
But the mortgage company saying, no, that didn't happen, even though they cashed the check?
That's correct. That's correct, Ian. He's got evidence. He's got the paperwork. In fact, 10 years ago, he received. He noticed that there was a change in his mortgage repayments, and they got in contact with the bank. And the bank apologized for the error, saying that they'd correct it. And stupidly, they believed everything was okay. But the bank's trying to foreclose on him at the moment, and things are getting quite interesting because they tried to foreclose on him in the summer of last year. And 400 people turned up to prevent the eviction.
Oh my!
We have in the UK. I know we have bailiffs. Your bailiffs are obviously in the court. Our bailiffs are like the equivalent to your sheriffs, where they turn up on the door and you know, okay, your sheriffs carry guns. Our bailiffs don't.
Okay. What do they carry?
Shaved heads. Shaved heads and their knuckles.
That almost sounds profane. Can you spell that for me?
A shaved head, effectively. They're knuckle draggers. They're just...
A shaved head. S-H-A-V-E-D? Shaved?
Yeah, like okay. Like buzz cuts. They just
have
buzz cuts.
Yeah, I was thinking something else too.
So they have no weapons except for their own fists.
Not officially, Ian, okay. Anyway, but these guys turn up and they expect you to leave. And what happened was in the summer is that 400 people turned up to stop the eviction. A lot of people that are very active in the activist community.
Did the bailiffs even bother to show up?
Actually, Ian, no, because obviously they realized that, it would cause a riot effectively.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on YouTube. The man's name is Tom Crawford. And if you just put Tom Crawford in, you'll see everything that's gone on. Where it gets interesting is that in the UK, again, the same situation is with a guest in the US. They don't. Is that the bumper music?
Yeah, stand by, Dean. You can tell me more about that here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're here, and we'll take your calls about it, whatever's on your mind. Coming up, the snow shoveling that is illegal. We'll tell you more about it on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
She just looks that bowl squeaky clean. She loves Dynavite.
I've just tried this wonderful, catalicious Dynavite for cats.
The vitamins, the minerals,
got all the stuff in it that cats really like.
You don't even have to put food with the Dynavite. She will eat the powder right out of the scoop.
I was thrilled when I heard Dynavite for cats was coming out because I'd seen the changes in my dog.
She is not scratching anymore. She's not chewing anymore. DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
Sammy, he's 13, 14 years old and running around a little bit more. His coat is a little bit softer and shinier.
Justin's eyes sparkle more. He bats at stuff. He kind of jumps around.
Daisy and Poopy have a cat tree in my living room, and lately she's been climbing up to the top, jumping
jumping up there, and then she'll climb back down, and then she's right back up again.
It is just the best Dynavite for cats.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to is probably so swamped with applicants that he or she is tough to reach. So call early in the day, before 8 a.m., before the palace guards arrive. You'll need your prospect's direct number, and here's a sneaky way to get it. Suppose the company's main number is 555-5000. You should call 555-5012. When someone says, "Good morning, Pam Johnson," you should innocently say, "Oops, somebody here must have written this down wrong. I was calling for Tom Frederick. What's his direct number?" If the very next thing you hear isn't Pam giving you Tom's number, it may be, "Good morning, Tom Frederick." For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, we've got Skype. You can Skype on in at username lrn.fm. Don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com. Now, you've heard about Bitcoin and you've heard about blockchains, but what does it mean for you? Well, you can head to the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin on March 28th through the 29th. That's coming up, and you'll find out. Keynote speakers include the world and include world-famous investor, economist, and author George Gilder. Also, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Adept, Sambala Nair, will be flying in from India. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, Charlie Schrem, and many other speakers are being lined up. It's the biggest Bitcoin event going, and especially since the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference will also be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. If you want a glimpse into the future going even beyond Bitcoin, you'll want to be in Austin, Texas on March 28th and 29th. Go to texasbitcoinconference.com, get your tickets there, and then don't forget to use code FTL to get yourself a $25 discount off the $150 admission price, which is already very affordable for these kind of conventions. And not only that, the Texas Bitcoin Conference will donate $25 to Sean's Outpost with every ticket purchase when you use code FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com. So you're getting an amazing price on a one-of-a-kind event, and you're also helping Sean's Outpost with their outreach and assistance to the homeless. Free Talk Live was there last year. We broadcast live from the event. We had a great time, and we're excited to be part of it again here in 2015. So we will see you in downtown Austin March 28th and 29th. Go to TexasBitcoinConference.com, grab your tickets, and use code FTL to be a part of the future. As we go back to Dean, he's on the line with us from over in London. Dean, you're back on Free Talk Live. You were explaining to us about a guy named Tom Crawford who apparently he had a policy that was insurance policy that was supposed to pay off his mortgage. And he says it happened. He says he's got the documentation. The bank company says it didn't happen. And then they tried to foreclose on his house, but 400 people showed up to essentially block that from happening. And that's kind of where you left off.
Yeah, so obviously there's been a bit of wrangling in the courts. Effectively, the higher court has said that the property's got to be foreclosed on. More people that have, some legal brains have now been involved and people that really know what they're doing with regards to, in the UK, we have a thing called civil procedure rules, which is a rules and regulations for the higher courts. I guess it's the same, the federal rules as, you know, that you have over in the US.
Okay.
And effectively, the all the paperwork that's put in the court file is fraudulent. There's no court seals. It's not what's called to the prescribed form.
So what you're saying is the court's in on this.
Well, this is the thing, Ian. Where do you separate between theory and evidence? Or the people that are working on it have actually come out on record and have got documentary evidence to show that the correct court seals are not being used. So there's no line of liability.
So wait a minute. So some of the documents have a seal, but it's the wrong seal, or they're just not sealed at all?
Just not sealed at all, Ian, which means that they're not signed off by the relevant judge. So there's no... How do you deal with that?
I mean, how does one even begin to challenge something like that?
Exactly, Ian. This is it, because who checks the checker?
Right, who watches the watchers, sure.
Exactly.
Oh, I guess you could go to the Judicial Conduct Committee or whatever the equivalent of that is.
And then, right,
of course,
but who
that's
watches...
a bunch of judges.
Who watches the watchers that watch the watchers watch the watchers?
In theory, the legislature in the United States, I guess, you could go to them, but that's
okay,
not going to do
you any good. Okay, and 95% of them get reelected. So, you know, nobody is really watching anybody.
Yeah, your judges are elected.
That's not true. Not everywhere. They're elected in some places. Here in New Hampshire, they're appointed for life.
Yeah, just say
by the governor.
Or until they retire.
Or they die sitting on the bench in the House of Lords and no one realizes they've died. That's happened.
So, I mean, it's frustrating. So what I'm hearing you say is that this guy's screwed. They're going to ultimately, the courts are going to rule in favor of the bank.
Well, it's got even more interested, Ian. To bring you up to date, that's what happened in the summer.
Mm-hmm.
The bank have now employed a group of paramilitaries to come and foreclose this property.
What do you mean by paramilitary?
Right. What's happened is, sorry, is that Daryl?
Yes.
Yeah. Hi, Daryl. Hi. What's happened is the bank have employed these paramilitaries that are that they're called an asset management specialist.
It's like a private enforcer.
Private knuckle draggers.
Okay.
And these guys are ex special forces.
Yeah, so like sounds like the equivalent of like a Blackwater or Z,
that's it, yeah,
or whatever they're calling themselves these days.
That's it. So the eviction, the alleged foreclosure eviction was last Friday. There was one small problem. Over 700 people turned up.
Oh, my goodness. Normally you lose momentum with situations this. It gets more and more difficult.
Oh, no. What's been happening, Ian, is you know the meme, I am Spartacus?
Yes.
There's now the meme, I am Tom Crawford, and Tom wears an English straw hat. And the visual is the hat with the writing, I am Tom Crawford. And what happened was is 700 people turned up. Again, this is all on YouTube. You guys can see it.
And when was this? When did the 700 people think?
Last Friday.
Okay.
Last Friday. Shut the place down. There was a police helicopter above, obviously watching what was going on. These guys turned up, and they turned up, obviously, to check to see what was going on. But stupidly, they didn't do their research, and they pulled up a road, which is a cul-de-sac. So they got surrounded.
Wow. Okay. And then what?
And they and you'll see them on YouTube denying who they are. Well, the joke of it was is that obviously with the access, you know, you can find anything about anything now. The guy that actually runs the business, they've got his face driving the main car, and they found his details on LinkedIn.
Incredible.
So they've actually. So not only are these guys trying to pretend that they're just citizens going about their business, they've actually lied who they are, and they are a bit part of this enforcement asset management company that are ex-special forces.
Interesting. Dean, would you recommend people who want to check this out, YouTube search for Tom Crawford UK? Tom Crawford London?
Tom Crawford. No, this is in Nottingham, which is in the middle of England.
Thank you for the heads up on this, and please do feel free to keep us in the loop as it develops, and I thank you for the call tonight.
Right, Nottingham, that's where Robin Hood, the real Robin Hood, was from.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. Robin of Locksley, and you know, hopped around there. The Sheriff of Nottingham was always after him. Maybe there could be some sort of real life Robin Hood that comes to help save this guy.
Sounds like he's got it taken care of. There's 700 real life Robin Hoods, I guess. The more things change, the more they stay the same in some ways, I suppose.
That's right.
Trouble in Nottingham. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. Coming up, teenagers banned from shoveling snow.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090. Call 1-800-467-5090.
Free Talk Live.
You know, and this is a realistic view. I mean, look, your kids are going to do drugs. Would you rather them do drugs with pimply-faced kids driving around town? Or would you rather them smoke pot in your house where you know what they're doing? I'm not saying I love the idea of my little boy who's 3 growing up and smoking pot. I don't. I would prefer he didn't. But I know that the human animal, as it is, likes to have its mind altered. And he's my son. He's probably going to do these things. And I'll tell you, I was in a lot of dangerous situations that if my parents had tried something different, maybe things would have worked out differently. I don't know. I'm not blaming them or anything like that. I'm just saying that we need to try new things. This war on drugs, not working.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
In every age, a technology is created that upends the foundations of society, the wheel. the printing press, the internet. Now, in a world sliding into financial chaos, a new technology is changing the way monetary systems work around the world. It is called Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a new form of money controlled not by banks, governments, or corporations, but through mutual commerce between free individuals. To learn more, visit weusecoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait, now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
Property.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you, of course, can dial in toll-free to bring up anything that you'd like. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. ExpressCoin, it's the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, bitcoins, Litecoin, or Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business. So you get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or by making a deposit at a local credit union. This solves your problem. If you've been thinking about getting bitcoins and you've been wondering how the hell you go about doing it, maybe you don't really trust the idea of meeting somebody in a dark alleyway or something like that to conduct a bitcoin transaction, you just go to expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the United States or Canada, expresscoin.com can help you, and you can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. It's free, of course, over at expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of your favorite cryptocurrency with no fee whatsoever when you use code FTL at expresscoin.com.
So how many of your Bitcoin transactions have actually happened in dark alleys?
None of them.
Because I've never had that experience.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know where you're getting your Bitcoin from. But
obviously a dark back alley somewhere.
Yeah,
but I don't know where that dark back alley is.
True. I mean, my transactions have never happened in a dark back alley, but in theory they could, because if you don't use expresscoin.com, the person you're meeting may want you to meet them in their car in a strange parking lot somewhere. I mean, you never know about these people, right?
Yeah, you never do.
True.
And they, next thing you know, they're taking you in a van down by the river. I mean, and so knows where that's going to happen.
Expresscoin.com. Go and check them out. So, Danica, you had a story tonight that I also had, and I wanted to jump into that because usually we all bring things in independently. We don't have any sort of a powwow session on show prep prior to 5 minutes before the show. So
you mean you don't get the memo from the Koch brothers and George Soros?
No, I just sort of randomly...
He doesn't put on his TPS report either.
Flit just around on Facebook and click on stuff. And, of course, I also did some digging on the Ross Ulbricht case, which I do want to talk about a little bit later on. But let's go with this one here, because teenagers are in trouble. And where is this happening?
Oh, that
They're trying to shovel snow, but they've been told, no, you can't do that.
Let's see. Where does it say they're actually from? I believe it's Bound Brook, New Jersey.
Okay.
You know, obviously a place where it gets a decent amount of snowfall. And this kind of hit particularly home to me because I, you know, as a teenager, I also did odd jobs getting money. I babysat. I raked leaves. On some occasions, I walked dogs. I house sat when I got older. So people are complaining that, teenagers don't have any sort of responsibility. They don't want to work. Well, that's because
they can't
work. I'm willing to bet that most teenagers, given the opportunity, are more than happy to go and do a little bit of work for some money. Because money speaks, and now they can't because stuff like this happens.
Well, it's super not just this, and we'll find out what you're talking about, but it's also difficult for regular businesses, sort of on the up and up that pay taxes and all that. It can be very difficult to hire a teenager. Under 18, there are restrictions and rules in various different places that some federal, some state.
Can't work more than 4 hours a day if it's during the week. No, there are some places to where they say you can't work more than 4 hours a day during the week.
Period.
Period.
Of school.
You can't work after 10 p.m. You can't do certain things. You can't the hot stove at McDonald's. You have to work the register.
Can't serve alcohol.
Can't be around knives.
Yeah, that's true as well.
You can't sell tobacco or alcohol.
Yep. So it gets very, very restrictive. So let's talk about what happened here.
Sure. So apparently the world isn't like what it was when I was a kid. This is what the author is saying. No more Kool-Aid stands. No more doing yard work for cash. No more shuffling snow, as the government now has their hands in everything, regulating all aspects of our lives. So then the author speaks, when I was a kid, I remember passing out flyers to do yard work, which would earn me in the range of about $15 to $20 a yard, raking leaves or mowing. I was also setting up a Kool-Aid stand at the street corner at the age of 8, garnering the attention from neighbors willing to pay a dollar for each glass. However, those days are over. During the recent snowstorm, the school was closed and a few high school seniors were eager to make some extra cash by helping out their neighbors. But moments into their venture, they were shut down by local cops.
Now, this makes sense. Why wouldn't you want someone who's young, high school guys, they're
a lot of energy.
They're strong, they got energy, they can shovel for a while. If you're 75 years old and inevitably there's probably some elderly folks there in New Jersey who have not yet moved down to Florida, who could probably use a hand taking care of shoveling driveways and things like that.
Or if you don't mind shelling out some money because you don't want to get out in the cold and do it yourself.
Sure.
Here they are providing a service from the market, and the cops have to step in and just say, oh, nope, can't do that. So the recent snowstorm caused Eric Schneff and Matt Molinari, were dumbfounded when they were shut down by police after someone called 911 complaining that the boys were passing out flyers offering snow removal services. So someone called 911. Did they really think that they were in trouble?
A busybody snitch called 911.
Right. And interestingly enough, I overheard a couple of state reps discussing this same thing here in New Hampshire. Yeah. While I was in the line at the legislative cafeteria on Wednesday.
And what were they saying about it?
Apparently what had happened, the teenagers were charged, or the claim is that they were soliciting without a panhandler's permit. It's not that they were working and not paying taxes. Mm-hmm. It's they didn't have the permit to be a panhandler.
Right, to ask for the sale, you need to have a permit.
In their own neighborhood.
Yes.
It goes on to say that there's a picture here that's also posted on the website. Clearly it says snow removal. Shovel your driveway, shovel your walkway. Prices are negotiable. Please text, call tonight or early tomorrow morning. It lists the boys' names and it lists both their phone numbers.
Okay.
So, and then the police chief talks, said that an officer was dispatched to the street because a resident called to report a suspicious person with curly blonde hair and a hoodie who was walking through yards. Now, it doesn't...
Of course the guy had a hoodie. He was walking in the snow.
It doesn't say that he had the hood on, and obviously they could see his hair, his curly hair. Mm. So maybe part of his head was shown, maybe all of it was shown.
Long hair, could be long curly hair.
Well, I'm just saying that they obviously had a good view of the person. He wasn't purposely trying to hide
hoodies,
his face.
People hate hoodies. Like these old people get very afraid.
I'm totally afraid of you wearing your cassette tape hoodie
right
now.
It's threatening. Oh. All the colors.
Yeah,
very threatening.
Get away from me. Gosh.
I don't have any cassette tapes, Ian.
What are those things?
So the officer told the young man that it wasn't safe to be out and to come back during the day.
Really?
Well, I mean, you know, I guess it was.
It wasn't,
you know,
safe when he got there.
Oh, yeah.
It was safe until the cops showed up with the man with a gun. It was okay until then.
Yeah, that boggles my mind. Yeah, I kind of agree that perhaps the kid should not have been walking 3 yards, because that's kind of rude anyway.
Well, who knows if that's even true?
Right, exactly. It doesn't offer any context.
The kind of person who calls the cops on someone walking around in a neighborhood is not necessarily the kind of person who is going to be fully honest about what was going on.
Oh, man, there's someone walking around, and you know, at night, I should fear for my
life.
Was
it nighttime? I would.
It says right here they told them that it wasn't safe to be out and to come back during the day. So it sounds like that it was at least, you know, after, you know, the sun had gone down. It was getting darker, it sounds
okay,
like.
Okay, so like 5:30.
Right, exactly. Yeah, you know what? People can't walk around outdoors when it starts getting dark outside?
Well, okay, so there's an argument that could be made that if it was actually dark out, then that's kind of weird. You know, maybe it was the getting dark phase. Maybe it was actually dark out. If it was the evening, I would say it's okay. But if it's nighttime, soliciting the neighbors for snow removal probably is not the best idea. I mean, that's going to make people a little nervous.
I totally agree.
Okay, so it's fully dark in New Hampshire. It is fully
at
dark.
At 4 o'clock.
At like 5,
at like
4 o'clock.
6:15, it is completely dark. Like, there's no more like residual sunlight.
Yeah. That's more late.
But it's five.
I would not say that 6 o'clock is too late to be walking around outside.
Sure.
Not walking around, but to actually like go up and knock on a door, I'd say it's too
people
late.
People aren't in bed yet.
That doesn't matter. More coming up here in moments. 855, 450 free. This is New Jersey, and there's fairly likely high crime in lots of places in New Jersey. There's more coming up. Free Talk Live.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lawns to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
If you're struggling to pay or haven't been making your student loan payments, listen carefully to this urgent alert. Have you been out of school for 10 or more years and you're still making your student loan payments? Are your student loans past due or even in default? Can't go back to school because of an old student loan problem? Fast Track Student Loans can get your student loans out of default, stop any wage garnishments, stop collection calls, and stop seizure of your tax refund. Give yourself a break. Stop the stress and get your student loan payments down to as little as $25 a month, based on what you can afford to pay. One quick 10-minute call could help you solve your student loan problems. So call right now. Not available in all states. Payments may vary based on income. 800-215-6813. 800-215-6813. 800-215-6813. 800-215-6813.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you'd like, talking about restrictions that may not have existed, or if they did, they were not enforced when you were younger. But now teenagers in New Jersey are under fire from the police for going around and offering to shovel some driveways, to shovel some walkways in
just
a recent...
trying to do a good hard day's work.
In a recent blizzard, or just before the blizzard, I guess, was when they went around passing out flyers to residents in one area of in New Jersey. I guess it was Bridgewater, Boundbrook, New Jersey.
Yes.
So we'll continue the story here. Also coming up, the latest on the Ross Ulbricht Silk Road trial. We'll let you know what happened in court yesterday. And that's all on the way. Your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us on Skype at username lrn.fm. So Danica, as I was looking through the story from IntelliHub, I noticed that there's another sort of more detailed version on USA Today, where the police chief says that the two young businessmen, the 18-year-olds, were not arrested or issued a ticket.
Oh, that's good, at least.
And the police's concern was about them being outside during dangerous conditions, not that they were unlicensed. Quote, "We don't make the laws, but we have to uphold them. This was a state of emergency. Nobody was supposed to be out on the road."
All right, so let me just sort of pause you there before you go any further.
Sure.
The police always say, "We don't make the laws," but yet every legislative hearing where there's, you know, a piece of legislation to modify a law in some kind of way to give people more freedoms or to, you know, prohibit something from being introduced to restrict a freedom, the police unions are always there
every time
talking about how if this passes, then, you know, children are going to die, puppies are going to commit suicide, the world is going to end.
Oh no.
This will be the downfall of Western civilization.
Yeah, they do take positions.
If this happens. And so then most of the time the legislates wind up doing what the police union request.
So, sure, because the police are so wise and benevolent.
They don't make the laws. They just influence them heavily to make sure that they're made the way they want to enforce them.
And kept the way they like them.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Lots of pressure and intimidation. Of course. They'll always get their way.
So, well, hopefully that'll start to change over time as more people move to New Hampshire because they're sick and tired of this nanny state garbage that's happening in so many other places and these restrictions on the ability to just, you know, start a simple business without having to go and ask some bureaucrat's permission. The cop here is also being dishonest, Daryl, when he says that we don't make the laws, but we have to uphold them. That's also not a true statement. The police don't have to uphold the laws. The police have discretion on almost everything. From what I understand, there may be a few things like certain felonies that they don't have discretion on. But from what I understand, that they generally have discretion across the board, and they can choose to not enforce the law at any given moment.
Right,
and
don't they use discretion when it comes to issuing out tickets if they pull
you over?
Of
course.
He used his discretion here. He didn't issue a ticket to the young men when he certainly could have. But he also could have used extra discretion and left them the hell alone in the first place. He didn't have to even talk to them. Now, I think that it would have been one thing to say to them, hey, look, again, what we don't know is how dark it was out. I think it's a little weird to go around knocking on doors after dark. You know, if the person can't look outside their front door and you know, easily identify the person who's there. And
sure.
You know, if you haven't ordered a pizza, you know, if you aren't expecting a guest, then it's a little bit strange
I would say 7 p.m. is the cutoff.
Well, I agree kind of with Ian that if it's dark enough to have to turn the lights on your car, you probably shouldn't be going around knocking on doors. I mean, what the boys could have done is, you know, maybe left a flyer in the doorway or under the mat so that they didn't disturb anyone.
That might have been what they were doing.
That's true.
It could have been.
We're jumping to conclusions here, right?
Yeah. Because it saw somebody suspicious walking through the neighborhood.
That's true. Yeah, they could have just been leaving in the mailboxes or something like that, which is also federal crime, apparently. But I remember when I was younger in Florida, I walked around. I had some sort of flyer. I don't even know what it was for, but I was walking around the neighborhood putting it in people's mailboxes, and I had no idea that was federal crime.
Sure, yeah, I've done that too.
And there was some people that were sitting outside of their house, and I don't know, I must have been in my early teens or something like that. And they started yelling at me for putting a flyer in their mailbox and were saying that it was a criminal act or something like that. And I just basically told them I don't care.
Oh.
And I kept going.
You told them.
But
did they wave their fist at you and yell, get off my lawn?
Well, I technically wasn't on their lawn because in Florida, at least where I was, you actually have mailboxes by the road. Here in Keene, New Hampshire, it's different from anywhere I've ever lived, where at least in the downtown areas of Keene,
all the mailboxes are right by the door.
Most mailboxes are right by the front door.
The houses across the street from the LRN studio, they're on the road.
They are new. Both of those are new, and I believe there may be some sort of new policy going into effect or whatever, where they're trying to shift to actual roadside mailboxes. But Keene, New Hampshire is a very kind of like classic mail person walking about destination. Like that's, it's kind of old school,
yeah,
I guess, in that way. So back to the story here at USA Today. So he claims this was a state of emergency. Nobody was supposed to be out on the road. Now, that's also an interesting claim because we were talking about these travel bans that went into effect in different places, New York, Connecticut, Massachusetts, they all had different times at which you were not allowed to be on the road. At least that's how it was reported. Is this officer suggesting that during the travel ban you are also not supposed to be walking? Because if that's the case, that's even more insane. The idea
you cannot leave your house until we tell you that you can leave your house.
Yeah, I mean, that's like, you know, the shelter-in-place thing during the Boston bomber where everyone's forced to stay inside.
I was just going to say, yeah, it reminds you of what happened with the bombings. It's crazy.
Over snow falling. And the ostensible reason...
It was snowpocalypse, Ian.
Well, didn't turn out that way. But the ostensible reason for these travel bans is that the roads are dangerous. Like, you know, your car could be a death trap, essentially, if you lose control. And
your
you're
car
more likely
could
to
always
control.
Be a death trap.
Sure, but you're more likely to lose control. I'm not supporting the travel ban. I'm just explaining the concept behind it, is that the roads are too dangerous. You can't possibly drive safely.
Yeah,
we'll be driving, but
ridiculous.
You can't.
So I'm not allowed to let my dog out because, you know, my dog obviously can't use the bathroom in the house. I mean, it's just
hold
like,
on. No,
is that
you can let the dog out. You just can't go out with the dog.
Well, the dog has more rights than I do.
There's probably laws against that in New Jersey, Daryl, letting a dog out unattended.
Put it on a leash and one of the little zip line things.
So again, just a strange thing, claiming that you can't even be out as just an individual walking around. The teens, they say, took the incident in stride and said the police told them that they only needed permission to go door to door, but were still allowed to shovel walkways if residents called them. So how would the residents know to call them if they weren't able to distribute their flyers to those residents?
I know. Are they supposed to be friends with all their neighbors on Facebook and send out this, you know, wide message that, hey, if you need your
walkway shelf?
I mean, that would work in some ways if they were, in fact, friends with their neighbors. Absolutely.
But how likely is that?
But how likely? Yeah. You know, I think, you know, the flyers, sticking it under a mat, putting it in, you know, the doorway. If there's like two doors, like one glass door and just regular door, put there. No one's affected. They're staying off the lawns. Like, you know, and again, it doesn't say if the kids were walking across the lawn. Like, across the lawn, not a nice thing to do.
The reports made the claim, but that may or may not have been true.
Exactly, yeah. You know, as long as they were staying off lawn and staying, like, on the walkway.
Maybe they thought they were on the walkway, but, you know,
it was too
snowy, and you...
Right,
you know, I can't really tell where all of the walkways are.
We're jumping all over the place here. I realize that there's like so many different ways of doing it, but bottom line is that we live in a nanny state. It's just horrifying.
That
it's
they
just
could
so
all
sad.
Just learn ESP and then communicate telepathically with all of the neighbors.
I wonder what kind of level of this there exists here in New Hampshire. It's where we're doing the show. I know there is such a thing as an itinerant vendor statute.
That's actually, I had mentioned that the state reps were talking about this, and one of the state reps said that in the town that he lives in, I forget the town, but it's somewhere out towards the seacoast, the town he lives in, they have such a thing as the itinerant vendor. So if you're going to basically be a panhandler or door-to-door salesman, you have to have one of these permit things to be able to, you know, go around and tell people, hey, I shovel driveways.
What about all those politicians that pass around all those flyers saying re-elect
me?
Oh, they
exempt themselves.
Where's the crackdown on that?
Yeah, that's the same thing. Political speech, so therefore that is exempt.
Well, no, they're just exempting themselves. I mean, it's not that it's political speech is somehow better or, you know, should be protected. It just is because they're politicians and they want exemptions.
Right, but courts have consistently ruled that things that are deemed to be pure political speech have extra protections over things that are, say, advertisements.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Same thing, you're advertising your campaign. It's straight up an advertisement. There's more on the way. You can share your thoughts. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you are the kind of person who would call the cops on these teenagers. We'd love to hear from you. It's Free Talk Live.
This morning, Sandra Snead wrote a joyful status. This miss is a soon-to-be Mrs. Over 300 friends liked her engagement post, and it got 76 comments. Sandra, you're one popular gal. Geico also has a comment on your status. Did you know you could save hundreds of dollars on your car insurance in just 15 minutes by switching to Geico? Just a way we're trying to help cushion a nice little nest egg for the future misses. Hashtag getting hitched. Hashtag savings.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBucks to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darrell W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, January 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.95 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,262 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports one day after unveiling plans for a record military budget that once again totally ignored sequestration and other spending caps, President Obama is now calling for Congress to do away with sequestration altogether. Obama is planning to unveil a new budget on Monday, and it is expected to include massive spending increases across the board, insisting the spending is necessary to help American families succeed. The reality, of course, is that the President and Congress have been basically ignoring sequestration since the idea was initially proposed, and the only time it comes up is when the Pentagon, which is constantly being exempted from it, continues to hype it in their quest for new record budgets. In the end, officials seem to have gotten the best of both worlds out of sequestration, ignoring the mandated cuts while it is in place and then looking for even bigger spending hikes afterwards to make up for cuts that never happened. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Wired reports a former federal agent has shown in a courtroom that he traced hundreds of thousands of Bitcoin from the Silk Road Anonymous marketplace directly to the personal computer of Ross Ulbricht. In Ulbricht's trial on Thursday, former FBI agent Iluam Yum described how he traced 3,760 Bitcoin transactions over 12 months, ending in late August 2013, from servers seized in the Silk Road investigation to Ross Ulbricht's Samsung 700Z laptop, which the FBI seized at the time of his arrest in October of that year. In all, he followed more than 700,000 Bitcoin along the blockchain from the marketplace to what seemed to be Ulbricht's personal wallet. Based on the exchange rates at the time of each transaction, Yum calculated that the transferred coins were worth a total of $13.4 million. Prosecutor Timothy Howard asked Yum, "You mean direct one-to-one transfers?" Yum responded, "Yes, direct one-to-one transfers." Yum's testimony represents another damning line of evidence connecting Ulbricht to the Silk Road. On top of a journal detailing the Silk Road's creation found on his laptop, and testimony from a college friend who said that Ulbricht confessed to creating the site. Ulbricht's defense has argued that despite initially founding the Silk Road, the 30-year-old Texan quickly gave it up to the site's real owners, who later lured him back just before his arrest to serve as the perfect fall guy. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports the U.S. Senate approved the controversial Keystone XL pipeline by a vote of 62-36 on Thursday, defying a promise by President Obama to veto the bill. 9 Democrats voted in favor of the Keystone XL pipeline, but the bill still does not have enough support to override a presidential veto. The House passed a similar bill recently, but its members must decide whether to merge the two bills or vote on the Senate measure. Senator Mike Enzi from Wyoming said in a statement that the Senate bill includes an amendment aimed at protecting private property, saying, "With the change in Senate leadership, the Keystone bill was considered in an open process, with senators from both parties being allowed by the new leadership to offer amendments. We were able to vote on more amendments on this single bill than we voted on in all of 2014. Keystone, first proposed by TransCanada 6 years ago, would carry Canadian crude oil to terminals in Houston and Port Arthur, Texas, and somewhere in southern Illinois. Most of the system has been completed, but the Keystone XL between Alberta and Steele City, Nebraska is still in the planning stages. Environmentalists have been fighting the pipeline. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The new Netflix Gas lets users instantly inhale multiple seasons of TV shows. An area man is worried the nation's healthcare debate might be getting political, and a bullied eighth grader incorrectly thought classmates would leave him alone during a field trip to the 9/11 memorial. Don't mistake my kind, gentle tone for one of love or support. This is The Onion Week in Review. According to a report released this Tuesday, no one, absolutely no one, will ever stack up to your eighth grade boyfriend, Brian Bowden, who you dated for 6 weeks in middle school. A 43-page study from Stanford University confirmed that no other guy in your life will ever be as kind or caring as the 13-year-old who held your hand during the scary parts of Jurassic Park, who had that really cool chain wallet, and who bought you two pink carnations on Valentine's Day. The report added that while your current boyfriend does have a lot going for him, he will certainly never cut class with you to listen to the Dead Kennedys' Frankenchrist on a Sony Discman. Brian used to do that with you. He used to do it all the time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Still to come here tonight, the latest on the Ross Ulbricht case with the Silk Road. He is alleged to be the operator of said Silk Road. It's now known that he is the creator of the Silk Road. That was admitted the first day of the trial. But there has been quite a bit that has happened since, and this is the third week. We may hear from John Bush. He is in the traveling mode at the moment, so I'm not sure whether or not he's going to be able to make it in tonight. But I do have some news about the case regardless. Of course, John Bush from thelibertybeat.com. He's been in New York City all week following along the trial and sitting in the courtroom and taking notes because, unfortunately, in federal court, that's all you can do. You can't bring a video camera into federal court. You can't even bring a still camera into federal court. You cannot bring your cell phone into federal court. You can bring a pad of paper and a pencil, and that's it. And so it's like sort of like flashing back to, you know, the 1800s where you had no other options for being the media. They really haven't changed anything very much in that amount of time. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And just a moment ago, we were talking about this news out of New Jersey where teenagers have been threatened by the police for going around handing out flyers offering to do some yard work. It was this kind of blizzard time, and these teenagers, enterprising young men, were going about from house to house, leaving information. And we're not sure if they were knocking on doors or not, or how late it was in the day. But presuming they were being courteous in the way they were handing this information out, I don't see what the problem is. Now, the police were saying that these laws, these itinerant vendor laws or whatever it is they're called over in New Jersey, are to protect residents. He said, this is the police chief there, Mr. Yanone. He says his department has no interest in cracking down on kids who want to shovel sidewalks. The law, he says, was made for transient scam artists who prey on the vulnerable. Quote, the spirit of the ordinance is to protect residents from gypsy activity. People will solicit door to door and target the elderly and get into their house. Now, is that a legitimate concern, guys? Danica,
obviously it had to have happened before to even, maybe it didn't, but let's just say it, you know, it probably happened enough times for that sort of thing to get past. And I mean, certainly it is, you know, there's definitely some very sketchy people out there, but I mean,
it's true. My grandparents had it happen to them when they were kind of going off into the realm of Alzheimer's and dementia or whatever.
Sure,
if the purpose is to make sure that you don't have scam artists enter into elderly people's homes, then obviously you need to outlaw being elderly, because there's all kinds of people that aren't itinerant vendors that get invited into elderly people's homes. You know, you have the cable guy that will come in, like, you know, my cable's not working. You call the cable guy. Cable guy comes in. You order a pizza. The pizza guy comes, you know. Sometimes
sure,
it might
things,
be cold outside.
But those are all things you ordered. Those are all things that you requested the pizza guy show up. You requested the cable guy show up, whereas
these are
people who are not requested. They're just showing up. They're soliciting.
Well, and there are times when you have somebody that poses to be the cable guy.
Yeah, that probably.
You have somebody that poses to be a telephone repairman.
Man, we've had reports of a gas leak around here. You're going to have to let me in to check things out.
A bunch of people had their cable box go out, so I just need to check on yours just to make sure that it's okay.
And that'll work. That'll work on some
people.
Sure, yeah.
You could even have a scam artist that is such a good scam artist that comes in and says, So we've got a bunch of scam artists that are coming around through the neighborhood. I just need to make sure that there are no scam artists inside your house.
I think there may be a scam artist on the line here. You're on Free Talk Live.
I can't believe you guys are letting this go. I'm sitting in the studio doing the production, and this disgusting, bigoted, racist bureaucrat just said that he didn't want gypsies running around. I mean, we're talking about in this nation, there are different peoples, Irish travelers, Romnichelles, Romani, different people of ethnicities, but this disgusting bigot just said that he didn't want in his town. If he said he didn't want Irish people walking down the street, you would have jumped right on that. I can't believe you guys have missed this gaping hole.
I didn't completely miss it. I just got sidetracked on the other points about just how insane it is to say that, you know, if we outlaw this, then it will never happen again.
Mark has personally taken on the gypsies as his own pet project to try to rescue their reputation.
Oh, how noble.
It's really nice. That's because Mark did the 23andMe thing and he found out that, you know, there's like...
What's that, the DNA test
thing?
Are you a gypsy, Mark?
I am not a gypsy. I don't know what the hell you people are rambling on about. The thing is
he
you
is
can't
a salesman
judge
for
somebody
living.
Based on their ethnicity, but for some reason in this country and most of the Western world, it's okay to just dump on gypsies. And I mean, you know,
well,
that's
and
so
he,
cool.
Hold on, just Mark, just not, real quick. Most people don't think of gypsy as an ethnicity or a race.
What do they think
what
of it
What do you
as?
Think they think of it as?
Just
people that have a donkey that pulls around a trailer and they play.
People
a violin
that are nomads. Growing up, I always thought that gypsy was a term for someone who was a nomad. I had no clue until I was in my 20s that gypsy was an ethnic term.
Yeah, well, I think you've got to be. I think
and I'm
be
a fairly intelligent person. So if I didn't know this until I was in my 20s, I can guarantee you that there's a bunch of people that listening to this show and people that aren't listening to this show that have no clue that gypsy is an ethnicity.
Gypsy is an ethnicity.
Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You know, when you go to urbandictionary.com and look up gypsy, the
you
definitions...
probably read half of those on the radio.
We discussed this last week.
Yeah,
didn't we?
You can't read urbandictionary.com definitions on the radio.
Sometimes you can.
Yeah, it's very
okay if
you
leave out half of the sentence.
Let me just say that they do not say nice things about gypsies on urbandictionary.com.
You know, gypsy is rarely synonymous with something nice.
But, yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't know if the police chief here was trying to indict an entire ethnicity with that statement. I think he was using it in the more colloquial version of these people are, you know, a gypsy as a term for somebody trying to take advantage.
They're just kids. Like I get being aware of your surroundings, but they're just kids, and they're wanting to earn some money.
They're not kids, Danica. These are 18-year-old males.
They're younger than I am. They are officially kids. And I'm considered a kid around by most of you people.
No, so I get the point that Ian just made. They're teenage males. Therefore, they are troublemakers. Mm. They're potential criminals. All they want to do is rape and pillage and do large amounts of illegal drugs.
Well, wait a minute. Teenage males.
Now, it's true that if you can't go out and shovel walkways as a teenager, that you are more likely to go out and commit some sort of crime, right? If the government has completely pulled out from under you the options that you could have to actually make a legitimate living, then you're more likely to go and do something illegal because that's the only option. That's the only few options they've left on the table are committing crimes in order to make ends meet.
Yeah, and they're not going to be able to, when they actually apply for other jobs, just say, hey, when I was a teenager, I shoveled walkways. You know, here's someone that I have as a reference that can vouch for me that I shoveled their walkways. I walked their dog. And it's preventing them from being able to have pre-job experience.
Yeah, that's true. And also, these guys aren't exactly hiding themselves. Their phone numbers were on this piece of paper. So it's not like, you know, the typical traveler scam where they're going to go and paint your driveway or something like that. And then the paint washes off the next time that it rains.
Who paints their driveway?
I don't know. Some people do this stuff. So the paint washes off the next time it rains or whatever, and you don't have their number. You don't have anything, because usually that kind of scam is a very short-term thing. Like, oh, yeah, we got this extra paint back here, and we're traveling. We're coming through the area, but we can only do this job today, and we'll give you a special deal. And then they do the paint job, they take the money, and you never see them again. And then there's no way to really track them down. There's no way to take them to court or get any kind of justice in that case.
And then when you call the number, it tends to be a dead number.
But it's if they give you one.
Yeah, if you do have a number for them for some kind.
So, toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. But is this necessary? Is this itinerant vendor ordinance necessary to protect the elderly, to protect those people who are more likely to be susceptible to a scam? Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
I have two cats and two dogs. All four of them are on the Dynavite. This stuff is amazing. The first day that I gave Sweet Pea and Daisy the Dynavite for cats, I did add a little bit of the Lick-A-Chops, and they absolutely loved it. All the vitamins, the minerals, you know, they also enjoyed the num-nums, the nub-nubs or whatever they're called, the treats that also came along with it.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
They're just running through the house. They're playing. My Sweet Pea will walk in front of me. She'll stop where she's at, drop and roll onto her back, and then expect me to rub her belly, just like a kitten. Daisy and Sweetie have a cat tree in my living room, and lately she's been climbing up to the top, jumping up there, and then she'll climb back down, and then she's right back up again. Oh, I'm sorry. I wish they would make a product for us humans to give us the same amount of energy and gunk that Dynavite for cats are given for my cats. The phone number is 859-428-1000.
859-428-1000. DINOVITE.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, January 19th, 2015, gold opened at $1,276.40. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,322.93, $661.47 for a half ounce, or $330.73 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,258.35, $661.47, and $330.73.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free here. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, a Twitter lawsuit may be dismissed if the Justice Department gets its way. Daryl's got that story, plus the latest on the Russ Ulbricht case. That's all on the way tonight here on Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Especially want to hear from somebody who would call the cops on a couple of teenagers going door-to-door in their neighborhood. Is that a crime? Is there something wrong with what these young men did, going around offering to clear people's driveways for money? You know, they're looking to make a few bucks at it. And there are plenty of people who would be more than happy to pay someone a few bucks to clear out their driveway for them. So toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. If you care about online privacy, you really need to know about ProXPN. It is a global virtual private network. And that means they encrypt your online data. Your internet service provider, they're probably saving all of the websites that you go to, all the search terms you enter. They're logging that stuff, and in many cases, for as long as 5 years. You can put a stop to that logging and that snooping by going and getting ProXPN software. It's free. You can download it for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, as well as Android devices. Plus, if you're a Linux user, there are instructions that'll make it easy for you to start up with Linux over at proxpn.com/FTL. Go grab the app, get started, and when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account to get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access to privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites, you can do it with code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50, as in 50% off the price of their annual account, which brings the price down to about $5 a month, which is an awesome deal. In fact, it's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Plus, there's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. You really have nothing to lose except your privacy. So go and protect it right now at proxpn.com/FTL, and don't forget code FTL50 as we continue here. The story is about that you brought in tonight, Danica, about Matt Molinari and Eric Schempf. They're young men who had the idea of being entrepreneurial, which is very rare, by the way, in kids these days, because the government school system basically saps it right out of them. And if the government school system didn't do a good enough job in destroying the entrepreneurial spirit of kids, because the whole thing in government school is that, oh, well, kids, you've got to get through government school so you can get your diploma, so you can then go to the government colleges and then get another college degree, so you can then go and get a job where you can have a career for your whole lifetime, your adult life, and then you can retire at age 65 and then collect Social Security. And nobody is ever encouraged to start their own business or to be entrepreneurial in any of that. There's no entrepreneurs class in any school that I've ever been to.
Or to gain, you know, like I said, pre-job skills that will help them when they go for that very first job in the first place.
Going door to door. I mean, lots of kids do this when they're very young. Were you a Girl Scout at any point, Danica?
Not a Girl Scout, no.
Did you ever do door to door, like, you know, popcorn sales or candy sales and things like that?
No, my siblings actually, when they were in Little League, both my actually, I did Little League too, but I didn't do this. My sister and my brothers did go door to door and sell candy bars. So
was it for like the government school, or was
it was for their Little League team?
Because I'm sorry, I missed that detail. So, but sometimes it's actually the government schools that have kids go and do this, which is kind of interesting, right?
We used to do that, and they would always have the prize for
whoever sold
the most stuff.
Mm-hmm. What were you trying to sell it for? Was it like some sort of drama class, or what was it?
No, it was never anything specific. Just school needs money, go sell stuff.
Really? Because I've seen it happen where kids have like an extracurricular kind of thing. Like, oh, we're going to go to Spain, or, you know, they're just coming up with some reason that they need to.
There would be like special things, but generally it was, you know, like, here's the little brochures, you know, this thick packet of overpriced crap.
Yeah.
Go try and sell this to all your neighbors. And
so it was just something they did.
School needs money.
They did that with the entire school.
Yeah.
Wow. I've never seen that. Now, the schools I went to were government schools down in Sarasota, Florida. And what they would have us do is they'd have these running events where they, I don't forget what they were called, but, you know, the kids would come out and the idea would be that they'd run around around the track, and then for every lap, you would get a count. Like, they would check off or something on your back or something like that. And then you'd have a total number of laps after you were done. But what you'd do before you this event, for the weeks upcoming to this event, you'd go around, they'd ask you to go around your neighborhood, knock on people's doors, and get them to pledge money to the school per lap.
Yeah, so, there would be special things like that that different clubs or organizations would do. And that was in addition to
this was the whole school, though,
like twice a year sort of thing where they give you the brochure of, you know, try and sell overpriced wrapping paper to your family.
So, I mean, I guess that is one way that I guess that's not really entrepreneurial necessarily. That's just encouraging kids to go and do the bidding of the schools. Although knocking on doors is an important concept for, you know, the idea of developing the ability to be outgoing, I suppose. But that's, I don't think that's the reason they do it at the schools. I think they're doing it because they want the money and they know that the kids don't really have to learn how to sell because they're a little kid and the neighbors, you know,
and they're
are more,
so adorable and oh, we'll totally buy that overpriced coupon book or that candy bar from you.
Yeah, I don't know how many houses out of 10 will go ahead and buy, but there's a decent amount of them that will go ahead and buy. Otherwise, they wouldn't waste their time encouraging the kids to do this kind of stuff.
Sure, so, absolutely.
So on one hand, the government has no problem putting kids to work for them to to, you know, make larger budgets for their departments. That's fine. Let's send the kids out. We'll give them an exemption from the itinerant vendor statutes. But if they get it into their head that they should be able to go door to door on their own volition to start their own business to benefit just themselves, and of course the people that they're providing the services to, then no. Then they're itinerant vendors, and then they're going to run afoul of the law.
Yeah.
But would the government cops... Had the government cops been going around and let's just say they got a call and these guys were actually doing a school fundraiser. Let's say they're seniors because 18, they could still be seniors,
they're probably seniors
at high
yes.
school. Let's say they're seniors in high school and there's a, like an end of the year bash fundraiser or something and they're actually raising money for the school. How much you want to bet if that cops came up and talked to them and they said, oh, well, they showed the cop, well, look, we're working with New Jersey High School or wherever it was that they were, Bound Brook High School, and we're trying to raise money for our graduation party. Do you think the cop would have turned around and walked the other way?
Oh yeah, that's fine.
Oh, do you have chaperones here? Are you, you know, did you contact the vendors to, you know, really sell that Dr. Pepper, or you should be using Shasta soda as a Dr. Pepper? How dare you?
What does it have to do with Shasta soda? I missed that.
I was making an exaggerated remark that they didn't get Coca-Cola's permission to use Dr. Pepper and said they had to go use a generic product like Shasta soda.
I'm totally missing what that's in reference to. Is that in reference to something I said?
No. I apologize. You know that they don't have permission to you know sell it or
well, but they would if they were out with the school. That would be the idea.
No, they would have the school. She's saying they would have the school's permission, but they might not have the permits from Coca-Cola. Authorizing the school to sell Coca-Cola.
Yeah, it's an exaggerated joke how far it may go.
Yeah, I expect they would turn right around. I expect the officer would not push it at all if he knew that the fundraising was being done for the school rather than the individuals. So the toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We'll go to your calls. If you are somebody who would call the police on some kids in the neighborhood doing who knows what. They're knocking on doors. You don't know. They haven't knocked on your door yet, but you're scared, and you don't want them to because who knows what they'll say to you. And I don't know what the motivation is for why somebody would be such a busybody to call these the cops on these guys. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here. There's more coming up. A Twitter lawsuit. We'll talk about it. Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Superbeta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Superbeta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090.
Call 1-800-467-5090.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Allison Fry and Peter Hartman are a long-term couple. They've been trying out an open relationship that frees them to emotionally burden and exhaust other people.
We're both grown-ups. We both trust each other. It just seemed like the right time to open ourselves up to meeting other people and barraging them with our crippling emotional neediness.
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. I still want to vent to Allison about all the anxieties I have at the office until she wishes I would just shut the f*** up. But sometimes you just get the urge to sap the life out of a different woman for a change.
The flexible arrangement has allowed Fry and Hartman to participate in a variety of tiresome and psychologically draining one-off encounters with partners ranging from close acquaintances to total strangers.
Of course, there was a time when I couldn't imagine saddling anyone but Peter with my extensive emotional baggage and trust issues, but now that we've tried it...
The best part is, when we're back together, all we really want to do is drain the living shit out of each other.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you're here to, we're here to take your calls. You can call in about anything you want, 855-450-FREE. You can also just listen. It's up to you. That's why we're here to hopefully entertain you and maybe do a little enlightening at the same time. But our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There's no guarantee that our callers will be enlightened. And we go to Chris Kringle, listening in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Chris.
Hey, how you doing? Hey, I want to, first off, before we go into the thing about people knocking on doors, I want to tell you, I want to thank Jesus for all the good things he does. And I want to thank Jesus for protecting my house and the alleys around my pad and protecting it from bad people out there, protecting me from the New World Order. And I want to thank the Lord for providing for me and helping me and undoing all the brainwashing of the public education system. And I want to thank you for straight A's last semester.
By the New World Order, I'm guessing you're not talking about Hulk Hogan, Scott Hall, and Kevin Nash.
Yeah, you got jokes. All right. Well, you know what? You cut me up. I want to thank the Lord for everything. You know, because without him, John 3:27, I'd have nothing. Okay, so look, anyway.
Okay, hold on, Pete, or Chris, whatever it is that you want to be called this week. I know you like to call Free Talk Live to pray, but the Bible also says that a man should pray in his closet.
Yeah.
And not do it publicly. It seems to me as though you were trying to, you know, like, show everyone how holy you are.
Very pious.
No, not at all. I just want
to. So why call a national radio show to say your prayers? Why not say your prayers at home in private?
Damn good question.
I wasn't saying my prayer. I was just in front of millions of people giving a dedication to the Lord and hoping that maybe
Sounded very much like a prayer.
Let's listen. I was hoping that they would stop being doing the lascivious activities you do, and they would turn to Jesus. Now, let's go to the thing about the door, okay?
The what activities the we do?
The teenagers were doing lascivious activities. The drugs. And God, is that right?
Yeah, of course. I'm an independent for a reason, because, you know, I agree with some of the libertarian stuff, but your thing is, oh, do whatever you want as long as it doesn't hurt. No, as long as it doesn't hurt me. The Church of Satan's title was, oh, do as thou wilt. I don't think so. I don't dig that. I do whatever you want to do. That's fine as long as it doesn't violate the Lord's law, the Ten Commandments. Now, can we go to the door thing or not?
All right, go.
Okay, look, common law. No victim, no crime. I don't think there's nothing wrong with somebody. It might alarm them, you know, especially if they're paranoid, but they should say, they should look to the people. They should say, state your business, you know. Why are you knocking on my door? Who are you, okay? And they should be armed also. But dig this. I mean, if the kids shouldn't jerk them around. If they have something that they want to sell and they want to do entrepreneurialism, then yeah, they should make the proposition. I have this for sale. You want to buy it? If they say no, they should leave the property. There's nothing wrong with that. But I think people are paranoid nowadays. But I think there's a lot of bad things going on to make people paranoid.
So you're saying let the kids go door to door, no problem.
Absolutely. Right. They have a right to do that as long as.
What if the kids were gay?
Let me tell you about that. About the Leviticus 23.
I don't really want to know about that. Thanks.
What if they ate shellfish or they wore cotton polyester blend clothing?
Wait, what are you getting at there?
Well, you know, there's in Leviticus, he quoted Leviticus,
okay,
or began to quote Leviticus, just several verses away from the passage that he was about to quote. There's a prohibition against eating shellfish, mm-hmm, a prohibition against eating pork. There's a prohibition against mixing cloth in your clothing. So if you mix cotton and wool, then you're in violation of Levitical law. If you wear cotton polyester blend, you're in violation of that law.
Nope.
So he's picking and choosing the parts that he wants to enforce.
Well, if we're doing that, then I might as well just go and get a cover for my head because, you know, it's terrible for me to be showing all of this magnificent hair right now.
Oh, yeah, and Mark is showing his tattoo, and there's the funny thing to where this, it's a very popular image on the internet of some high school kid that went out, got a tattoo of the Bible verse prohibiting homosexuality in Leviticus. And two verses later, there's a prohibition against inking one's skin.
Right, because your body's a temple and all that?
Yes.
That kind of thing. Let's go to Jamie in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live listening via the TuneIn app. Hello, Jamie. You're on with Ian, Danica, and Daryl.
Hello, all.
Hi, Jamie. Go ahead.
This idea of prohibiting people going door to door is not a hyped up post 9/11 type of thing either, as so many other things.
Oh, no, this is old. I mean, itinerant vendor statutes have been around for a long time.
I had the same thing happen to me in about 1998, 99. I was out of work, and I went and rented a backpack blower for blowing leaves, threw a ladder on the top of my car, and started going around cleaning gutters.
Okay.
And I did, you know, 15, 20 jobs, made some money, had some cash in my pocket, happy customers. People, you know, called me back for years. Well, while I was out doing that, some busybody called the cops, and I'm driving along, and all of a sudden I get pulled over.
This is how many years into this, just to be clear?
This was the second year that I had done this.
Got it.
Wow.
And
you're how old?
Going door to door. At the time, I was 22.
Okay.
And
cops got called, so what happened?
They pulled me over, start questioning, you know, what are you doing going door to door, so on and so forth, and I tell them. And the busybody, who usually they tend to keep to themselves and watch through the blinds, he comes running out his door. He's a guy. This is the guy. He's He's knocking on everybody's door. I saw him climbing on their roof.
What?
And I said, yeah, I was cleaning their gutters.
Right.
That's why I'm climbing on their roof.
I have to climb the roof to clean their gutter. Who would have thought?
Right. Why else would someone climb on their roof to shimmy down the chimney or something like that?
Or to be a chimney sweep. Or to install shingles.
But, like, for what nefarious reason, right? Like, the busybody is thinking there's something nefarious going on, obviously.
Nefarious, you're probably trying to remove the gutters, steal the shingles, you know, something, you know, like, put explosives in the chimney.
Yeah, I'm sure old gutters are going to sell real well on the secondhand market.
Old
moldy gutters.
Take it in, you know, aluminum. Nothing.
Sorry, Jimmy, go ahead.
They're worth practically nothing. They are aluminum. You could sell them, but yeah, how are you going to go ripping gutters off of people's houses without being noticed?
Right. So that's a shock, though. The dude actually comes out. I think you make a good point that usually the busybody wants to remain anonymous.
Yeah, they hide because
this person was willing to come out and get in your face. So what happened?
So the cops told me there's ordinance, blah blah blah, number whatever against, and that I need a permit and a business license, and I basically told them to go scratch and that I was going to be on my way and they wouldn't have to see me again. So I didn't go back to that town, but I continued working and I made some money and I made some people happy, but it was pretty shocking.
You know, the thing they really don't like about you is not that you could be scamming people, but the fact that, you know, an itinerant vendor or whatever, which is somebody who travels about selling things, an itinerant vendor is competition for the established vendors in town. There are people who have paid for licenses and they have paid for, you know, the government permits and bribes and all that. And they believe they have an exclusive right to market their services to the people in the area because of that. I'm not saying I don't agree with him on that, but that's certainly the motivation here, I think. I think that's where these laws really come from, because you, as somebody who doesn't have a base of operations that costs a whole bunch of money to maintain, you don't have a crew of people that you have to pay to go out and do the jobs for you. Your costs are next to zero. Your costs are what the cost of gasoline are, the cost of your time to go door to door. And that means you can compete at a level that, you know, Johnny's gutter cleaners in town can't compete at, and that's why they didn't want you there. Thanks, Jamie, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, but the claim is it's to protect all of the vulnerable old people out there from being taken advantage of. And certainly, elderly folks can be taken advantage of. There's no doubt about that. So we'll come back here with more. You can share your thoughts. But do we need the government to step in and protect everyone from every door-to-door salesperson? I don't think so. It's Free Talk Live.
Retrievers, Labradors, Goldens are the main breeds that come through our door, but we'll train anything with four legs and a tail. My husband and I train hunting dogs and also have a boarding and grooming business. And our dogs, they're athletes, and we feed them very quality food. You can't get enzymes in a commercial dog food because they cook it at such a high heat, but adding Dynavite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Dynavite the mom.
Tell everybody we know about Dynavite.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite. If it's working, don't quit.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite, it's time to place my order.
Dynavite.com.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com. It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Worried about getting sick and feeling terrible for days or even weeks? You need Immudyne for a healthy immune system. Why get sick and bother with products that just don't work? For just $1 a day, Immudyne is all natural and safe for all lifestyles. Call 866-257-8668 to buy now before it's too late, before you get sick. Or go to immudyne.com, immudyne.com, or call 866-257-8668.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll free here and bring up anything that you want. Have you ever been an itinerant vendor? We'd love to hear your stories about your interactions with the police, because inevitably the longer you do something like that, the more likely some busybody is going to call the cops on you. Now, you know, the other side of this is that not just an itinerant vendor is unwelcome as far as the possibility that they might be a traveler or something taking advantage or attempting to take advantage of people who are less than fully mentally aware, maybe some elderly folks with dementia or Alzheimer's taking advantage of those folks. I had some grandparents that had a situation like that. And does that mean that we need to turn to the government? I mean, Daryl, isn't there some other way? Is there any other way to protect people from being taken advantage of?
Certainly. There are, you know, lots of ways to protect people from being taken advantage of. One way is to warn people when you find out that there's a scammer in the area. Something else you could do.
Yeah, but is grandma on Facebook? I mean, you're not going to be able to give her a heads up.
Grandma still has a telephone.
Okay. But, okay, so are we talking about a phone tree where one neighbor would call another neighbor to let them know?
That's certainly one way.
Yeah.
In Detroit, they have the threat management centers that actually go out, and instead of responding to crime, they're out, you know, patrolling to prevent crime. Because when you've got a presence of people who, you know, are, for a lack of a better term, crime stoppers, then the crime makers aren't going to do crime.
So if you've got any ideas here, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's probably not a good idea to allow elderly folks who have dementia or Alzheimer's or the onset of it to really be alone. And because the police are always going to be too late. The police are only going to respond after someone has already called.
Right, but it's not just people with Alzheimer's and dementia that get taken advantage of.
Okay,
and
true.
It's not just the old people that get taken advantage of.
But it's a lot
of.
Easier to get somebody with dementia to sign a check to you from their bank account.
And it's not just itinerant vendors that take advantage, or people posing as itinerant vendors, or people posing as a fake, you know, cable guy. You've got people, and I've seen, you know, all kinds of undercover video from various places. Can't find it in New Hampshire because it's illegal to do undercover investigative reporting in New Hampshire. But
due to the terrible wiretapping
statutes.
But
most places, they've got, you know, one of the local TV stations will do some kind of thing like, you know, six on your side, where they go in, they find out.
I love that stuff.
You know, there's some car dealer or car mechanic that's, you know, ripping people off.
Or
so they go in with a brand new car that they know nothing is wrong on. And the mechanic comes out. Oh, yeah, so we're going to have to change out your
canuter
valve.
You're going to need a new flux capacitor. It's $1,000.
Yeah, you know, all these kinds of things, some of which are actually car parts, some aren't. And it's going to be like, you know, $3,000 before I let you drive it back out of here because this is unsafe.
So wait, what are you saying? You're saying that
saying that there are all kinds of people that try to scam people. It's not just itinerant vendors.
Well, yeah, absolutely. But it's easier to target them, right, because they are the ones walking around from house to house, whereas if somebody has an auto repair shop, they're more established. They've paid their licensing fees, so they're more likely to be left alone until there's some sort of serious allegation.
And they've probably been in business for a while, so, they have a reputation. People
trust
them.
They might even fix the police's cars in that place.
And then, you know, you've got the people that are just, you know, for lack of a better term, bums that will just hang around and bug people for money.
Legal now in Florida, by the way. When I went down there, they actually had legalized, due to a lawsuit, they had legalized panhandling on the side of the road.
Okay. I don't have a problem with panhandling, but, you know, point of the conversation was, you know, how do you protect people from being taken advantage of or giving money to people?
You can't.
You can't.
I mean, all you can do is educate.
You can try to help people. Right. You can try to prevent.
It's kind of like, you know, etiquette
scam
when you're,
people.
Right. When you have email, for example, you know, obviously, you know, don't ever, for example,
Are you going to tell me that the Nigerian prince isn't actually sending me $2 million?
That's a classic example. I am so glad you brought that up. Hmm. But certain companies, such as Blizzard Entertainment, for example, will always tell you, don't ever put your username or your password or email address in anything. If someone is asking you for those, that's not a real Blizzard employee. Mm-hmm. Don't do that. So they're telling you right up front, these are unsafe practices. So something like that is, like, if you get an automated email that's asking you to do that, that's not an email generated from our servers. Don't answer that email. You know, it's advice like that. It's education like that we can take to, you know, if you're not expecting someone at your door and someone's knocking, probably better to just not answer the door in general. I mean, that's always been a safe practice.
Yeah, I think so.
Like you said, education is key to preventing these kinds of things from happening. And, you know, the elderly, if they have Alzheimer's and forget that they shouldn't be answering the door, I mean, it's got to be very tough because they forget for lack of it. So, you know, do they need constant supervision or someone always around with them to make sure they
don't
do
that? A lot of
them
probably do, and they don't. Maybe their family members don't know. You know, maybe the dementia's been sneaking up, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. And there's a bunch of people that don't have dementia that just keep making very bad decisions that probably need constant supervision.
I'm so sorry to hear about your situation with the Nigerian prince, Darla. That's just
gotta learn the hard way sometimes.
Yeah.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So I guess that pretty much exhausts. I think we've exhausted this topic unless somebody else wants to call in with some itinerant vendor stories. Maybe you have actually been a door-to-door salesperson. And, of course, there's also the sort of the other side of the story, which is working as one of these folks for some very shady companies. Like the classic example is, of course, the magazine sales teams that hit the streets. They're like usually teenagers, late teens, early 20s, and they get, you know, they respond to some sort of a job listing on Craigslist or whatever, that easy money, you get taken care of, a place to stay, that kind of thing, and then they end up shipping them off to some place nowhere near their home, working them for 16 hours a day, and, you know, trying to sell magazine subscriptions to people. And it's a very, very kind of intimidating, scary environment where a lot of the other people working for the group will be drug abusers or violent, like the people who are the managers are sometimes accused of physically harming the people that are working for them. The magazine, I think they call them magazine sales teams or van magazine salespeople. Like, if you go and look that up on Google, you'll find all kinds of just horrifying stories about people being just left out in the middle of nowhere after, you know, they didn't make their sales quota, or they questioned the boss and got into a spat with the guy who's in charge, and just kind of get left in the middle of nowhere. And of course, they're already 1,000 miles away from home. So how do they get home? They don't have any money.
And most of those kinds of jobs, they wind up telling you in the interview, oh yeah, you're going to make, you know,
bank,
hundreds of dollars,
right,
a day, you know, like $200-$500 a day.
Right.
And then turns out it's commissioned, and if anybody cancels the subscription, then you wind up the next paycheck, you wind up having the chargeback or whatever it's
revoked,
called.
Yeah, sure, from your money.
And so, you know, 1 week, yeah, you might make $500 one week, and then the next week you make $32 because everybody canceled their magazine subscription.
What a horrible job.
Well, I actually had a girl stop by the LRN studios, and it was years ago, and I don't know how many of the stories I'd heard of this happening. I knew enough to be aware of it, and she actually was trying to sell magazines, and her pitch was that she wanted to sell the most magazines so she could go on a trip, some sort of a trip to Europe or whatever. And the look in her eyes was so weird. It was like the vibe I got from her was, don't let this girl in your house no matter what, she's going to case the joint kind of vibe. Like, she seemed really untrustworthy. It almost looked like she was on drugs or something like that. And I should have really asked her if she needed help, but ultimately I just, you know, refused the pitch because she looked like she didn't really want to be there, but kind of was anyway, and was going through the motions and going through the pitch. It was a very strange.
I'm here to sell magazines, and I would like to sell the most
excited
magazines, because then I could go to Europe.
No, she was more excited. She was very, like, had I not been aware of this scam, then I would have, you know, I'm not saying I would have fallen for it, but I could see how someone would have fallen for it, because she was young, she was pretty, she was persuasive.
Hold on, so are you saying that they're not actually selling magazines?
No, they're selling magazines, just they're selling them at way too much money, and it's just...
They're being really pushy about it, and
yeah,
trying to guilt trip you into, you know, support my job.
Yeah, it's buy magazines to help me. I need this trip or whatever. And it just seemed really disingenuous to me. But at the same time, I could see why somebody would fall under her spell. More coming up here, 855-450-FREE. The Twitter lawsuit is being possibly thrown out of court. What's it about? Daryl's going to inform us here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
How fast are new Allegra gel caps?
I didn't know you got a cat fast.
How strong are new Allegra gel caps?
10 more lots to go strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gives you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms in just 1 hour. 2 times faster than Claritin, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's relief when the pollen's off the charts strong, even in the convertible.
New Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster. Nothing's stronger. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Anti-war, pro-free market. That's antiwar.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, get $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, January 30th, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,258, silver $16.94, and Bitcoin's trading around $243.35. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Your job, your home, your car, your money. All these things provide you with a sense of security. But what about your family security? What have you done to prepare if all of these things were suddenly gone? eFoods Direct has the food security you need for every emergency. eFoods Direct is food security. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for 50% off their food preparation planning packs. In the news,
arrest Henry Kissinger for war crimes! Arrest Henry Kissinger for war crimes!
While appearing before the Senate Armed Forces Committee, former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger was confronted by protesters calling for his arrest. Activists with Code Pink interrupted the proceedings, holding a banner and carrying handcuffs. Senator John McCain referred to the protesters as
low-life scum
when demanding the Capitol Police remove them.
If we can't get the Capitol Hill Police in here immediately,
McCain apologized to Kissinger.
I have never seen anything as disgraceful and outrageous and despicable.
Ross Ulbricht trial, day 9. As the jury heard testimony from former FBI agent Ilhwan Yum, who testified about the role he played in seizing and analyzing Silk Road servers in Bitcoin. Also of significance yesterday, the government began the story of a Silk Road vendor who threatened to release the names of thousands of user identities if Dread Pirate Roberts would not pay him $700,000. It was this threat that would lead Dread Pirate Roberts, as shown to the jury on TorChat, to tell a member of Hells Angels Canada that he wanted to see his blackmailer executed. As the tension rose, the day's proceedings came to an end, just before the government laid out the details of the alleged murder-for-hire arrangement. It was apparent that the prosecution was raising that evidence just before they rested their case. The Liberty Beat's John Bush, covering the trial in New York, says that judging by the faces of the jurors, that aspect of the case may have an impact on their decisions. The Liberty Beat's continuing trial coverage continues next week. See thelibertybeat.com for details on how you can help keep that coverage happening. Support for the Liberty Beat Silk Road trial coverage comes from the Free State Project, where thousands of liberty-loving activists are moving to New Hampshire, including Ross Ulbricht's mother, Lynn. Get 101 reasons to move into an amazing and growing community of awesome libertarians and voluntarians at freestateproject.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 30th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. The U.S. Senate Thursday afternoon approved a bill to complete the construction of the Keystone XL pipeline. The bill passed with a vote of 62-36, including support from both Democrats and Republicans. The pipeline, which would run from Canada's indigenous lands through Nebraska and into Texas, has been heavily debated for 6 years. President Obama has stated he will veto the bill. Indigenous communities in Panama's Gabe Bugle region will be meeting with Panama's vice president and government officials after giving the government a deadline to cancel a planned hydroelectric dam. The indigenous communities warned the government they would take forceful measures if President Varela did not cancel the project by February 15th. The community members say the Barro Blanco project would affect more than 2,000 families. Victoria Nuland, the Assistant Secretary of State for European and Eurasian Affairs, condemned Russian state news agency RT and its, quote, tiny, tiny audience over recent coverage of the conflict in Ukraine. Nuland said the media agency spews lies about who's responsible for the violence in Ukraine. While speaking at a Brookings Institution event in Washington, D.C., the assistant secretary said the Russian media was lying when it reported the Ukrainian army was representing NATO's interests and also denied claims that Ukraine was behind a rocket strike that killed 30 civilians. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is sponsored by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, comedy-minded and liberty-focused. Live each Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 30th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Video game players love customizing every aspect of their character. One game, Elder Scrolls Online, has set a new bar for character creation by letting players design every organ and cell in their avatar's body.
In Elder Scrolls Online, you get to play as whoever you want to play. You are in control of everything from your character's face to their hair to their arteries. We're not just going to give you some pre-made bones and ligaments. You get to create the musculoskeletal system that's right for you. You can even alter the DNA.
Are all of these changes just cosmetic?
No, not at all. They have a huge effect on game playing. If your character's body has any anatomical flaws, they could die immediately.
Beta testers say that designing every aspect of their character is a compelling experience.
I've been designing my orc's liver for 5 hours now. This is awesome.
Designing the hands is the hardest part. I keep having to look up how all the joints connect.
Players can also press the randomize button to get a completely random collection of body parts.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Launching into the third hour of the program, you may dial toll-free here and bring up anything that you'd like with you in studio. It's me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
Don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com. And you can connect to us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Still to come here tonight, Daryl, you've been wanting to talk about a Twitter lawsuit for quite a while.
Yes.
And we never have, so you'll have to tell us what that's all about here in a moment. But first, we have Dave, who's in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Dave.
Yeah, I wanted to update you guys on the situation with jury nullification in New Hampshire.
Yes, please do.
Unless you guys reported on it in the last couple of days, I think this is probably going to be news to you. There was a new bill that went before committee hearing, I think, yesterday. That sort of takes the offensive and tries to toughen up the language of the law so it's more favorable to jury nullification.
So we were actually at that hearing yesterday, and the bill in question would require a judge to read what they call the Wentworth instructions. Wentworth being a state Supreme Court decision from, I believe, the 70s. And if the judge fails to do that, then it would be maladministration, which is...
Well, no, they're already reading Wentworth.
Not necessarily.
Oh, really? I thought that was a requirement.
No.
Here's what
it's a suggestion.
Here's
what it said on the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance page. This is a quote. It says, HB 246 relative to jury nullification. This is an incremental change to the 2012 law. Adding that any judge that denies or limits the right of the defense to inform the jury of their right to judge the law, in addition to the facts of the controversy, shall be guilty of maladministration, an apparently impeachable offense. And the hearing was on the 29th. So it makes it so that they've got to allow it in.
Well, it is an incremental change. One of the big complaints I have about this, and to bring our listeners up to speed, New Hampshire... back in 2012, the state legislature did pass what was touted as a jury nullification statute, which used some of the language that you mentioned there, but doesn't actually say jury nullification. The language has to do with judging the facts and the – what was the exact statement, Dave, since you have it in front of you, judging the facts and the what?
Application of the law.
the facts.
Any judge that denies or limits the right of the defense to inform the jury now gets a penalty, basically.
Of the facts. What's the exact language,
Dave? The facts and the application of the law.
Sure. I'm just wondering if Dave can read that back.
Well, again, this is just someone writing. It's not the actual text of the law, but just adding that any judge that denies or limits the right any judge that denies or limits the right of the defense to inform the jury of their right to judge the law.
Yeah, you're right. That's not the text of the statute. The text has something to do with the facts in the case. And
there's another law or another bill that has a hearing coming up next week. And that actually is the one that has the hearing next week is better than the one that had the hearing yesterday.
Okay. Better in what way?
I'll read the text. It's two sentences. It's not legalese.
Okay.
It says, in all court proceedings, the court shall instruct the jury of its inherent right to judge the law as well as the facts and to nullify any and all actions it finds to be unjust.
That is much better.
The court shall allow the defendant or counsel for the defendant to explain this right of jury nullification to the jury.
That is much better, and I hope that it even has a chance, because what happened originally, and this was actually addressed this year in the court case with our co-host Rich Paul, where he appealed his conviction for marijuana sales. But basically, the court overturned the existing so-called jury nullification statute by pointing out that the legislature, what they were originally proposed, actually used the word nullification, like the one that you just read there, Daryl. It actually uses nullification and nullify in the statute. But then before that got passed, they gutted those words out of there and they made it kind of a watered-down version. And so the court essentially said that this is not a jury nullification statute. They said that had it been a jury nullification statute, they probably would have overturned it as unconstitutional. So ultimately, even if this one, Daryl, that you're talking about does pass, the court has essentially issued a threat saying that anything that references jury nullification, we will mark as unconstitutional. And they cite some old court cases.
All from like 1813 and 1869. What needs to happen in New Hampshire is for the New Hampshire Constitution to be amended with the wording of the bill that I just read.
Yeah, that's correct. So, Dave, thoughts?
What was the hearing like? I mean, what's turnout like? Did any jerk judges show up?
Actually, no. The only two people who spoke against jury nullification was an attorney for the Supreme Court and an attorney for the who is the other person? Attorney for like a group of attorneys or something like that. Because I know the New Hampshire Bar
the Bar Association. I think you had said. I was actually at another hearing that would, if passed, grant immunity to someone who overdoses or someone who seeks help for someone who overdoses.
Yeah, that seems like really interesting.
The turnout was decent, though. I mean, the room wasn't packed full
of
people.
And there was also the conceal carry bill that was having the hearing at the same time.
Which had a huge amount of
Which had a huge hearing and wound up going for like 4.5 hours.
Yeah.
Conceal carry. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to say, I actually spoke at this, but unfortunately there was a problem with the recording, so that didn't end up. It's not going to end up making it out, but I did also record Rich Paul when he spoke, and he did a good job talking to these guys. The people on the panel, this judicial committee of state representatives, did seem unusually attentive. Something I noticed about them was that they were actually looking at me and making eye contact with me, which in a lot of cases when you speak to these panels or these committees in the state house, half of them aren't even there. In this particular case, it was probably 3/4 of them were actually attending, which is very, very unusual that there's so many of them there. And they were actually watching me rather than diddling around with whatever paperwork they have in front of them or talking with one another or just completely looking off in some other direction, which is in some cases how they behave. But most of them were actually paying rapt attention and seemed very, very interested. After the hearing, I actually had one state rep approach me and ask me for my business card because I had indicated that I was speaking as a board member of NHJury.com. And so he asked for a business card. He said he hosts a talk show in Manchester on television, and he was interested in, you know, talking about the issue of jury nullification. So there were some real positive responses. He was just one of a few of the people on that panel who had nice things to say both inside the panel discussion or the committee discussion and outside afterwards about jury nullification. So the odds of this thing getting through the committee positively, I would say, are decent, but you never know until the vote's actually taken.
Yeah, I think this concealed carry thing is going to pass within the next 6 years. I don't think it'll pass this time, although it might. But it's getting very close to where we won't have to have any kind of permissions at all to conceal carry.
Well, that was the proposal that Daryl was referencing. There were well over 100 people apparently at this event, and lots of people spoke, maybe only about 10%, according to those who attended. About 10% of the speakers were speaking against allowing concealed carry with no permit, or Vermont carry, as it has been called. That is currently on the table. And, you know, the sad thing is, Dave Ridley, and by the way, this is Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com. The sad thing is that it seems relatively simple to get 100 people to show up to support increasing gun rights in New Hampshire, but we don't ever see 100 liberty activists at the state house on a regular basis when we're there.
I don't see a dozen liberty activists at the state house.
Dozen. There's a dozen at least within the state
reps. Okay, if you count the, sure. I'm not counting the state reps.
Okay.
I'm talking about activists going to testify to committees.
Well, we're not
there's
in every
not
committee.
A dozen.
We're not in every committee. I would say there's a, because we usually bring about 3 or 4 out from Keene, and then there's probably another several from all over the rest of the state. I'd say maybe a dozen during the week.
What would change that is if, you know, we there are a couple of sort of free stater hangouts in Manchester. They're sort of like houses that are, they're a little bit like the Keene Activity Center, right? But there's nothing like that right next to the state house.
Mm.
If there were, that's what would change it.
Yeah, that'd be a good idea, and that might actually attract more movers to the Concord area. You don't really get the impression that there really is anybody living in Concord, except for Joel Valenzuela, who just moved up there, and maybe a couple other guys like Kevin Bloom, who's a great activist. And anyway, we're out of time for you, Dave. Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. More coming up. 855 450 free. The Twitter lawsuit is on the way.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The U.S. Constitution protects our freedoms through a system that separates and confines government power. America's founding fathers were wary of government and tried to use the Constitution to limit its reach in many ways. They divided the government into 3 branches, legislative, executive, and judicial, each able to limit the actions of the others. While this system can lead to what some people call gridlock, our founders considered it the best system for preventing politicians from violating our most fundamental rights. They also separated the national government from state governments, leaving most power at the local level. Our founders added a Bill of Rights that further limits the power of government. The Constitution doesn't create efficient government. It was created to protect us from government overreach. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippie!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and weed, the road to freedom. a film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And get yourself a free pound of some of the best coffee out there. From BuzzBox, it's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. All you have to do is pay the shipping cost, and they'll send you the pound for free. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. Now, once you get the first pound, you'll be on their auto-ship program, which you can adjust how often you're sent coffee and how much coffee and the type of coffee. So go and get started at coffee.freetalklive.com, and know this, that you're going to be helping people in poverty with an opportunity to change their own lives by providing microloans. That's what we're doing with some of the profits from coffee.freetalklive.com. We're giving them over to kiva.org and selecting different folks around the world to give them microloans. And you're helping us with that. Every 10 listeners actually helps us fund one new microloan on a monthly basis over at coffee.freetalklive.com. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We were talking with Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com about some of the jury nullification statutes here in New Hampshire. One of them was basically gutted earlier this year, or I guess not this year,
2012.
But 2014. Well, the 2012 statute was, first of all, it was gutted before it was even put into law.
Right.
But then it was further gutted at the end of 2014 in a Supreme Court decision that basically
technically
said,
it wasn't. Because the way people, just because somebody misrepresented what a statute was, doesn't mean that it was a jury nullification statute.
Well, a lot of people thought it was a jury nullification statute, and
right.
even
and
we
a
were
lot of people think that you know, rainbows come from unicorns. That doesn't mean that rainbows actually come from unicorns.
I thought it was a pot of gold. Where are you getting unicorns?
No, the pot of gold's at the other end.
Oh.
So,
oh, okay.
You know, just because somebody is told that it's something and they believe that it's something doesn't make it that
well,
thing.
I believed it and read it. I wasn't told it. I read it, and it reads as a kind of more nebulous-sounding jury nullification statute. If you, the way you read it, and I don't have it in front of me at the moment, but it's written in a way that it could be interpreted as
jury nullification. It could be interpreted as jury nullification.
What happened at the end of 2014
it could also
was
be
it was,
interpreted that it's not,
and
that's how it was interpreted by the Supreme Court.
Right. At the end of 2014, they basically overturned officially this statute by saying this is not a jury nullification statute. Essentially, what they said was the statute is null. It does really nothing.
Right.
The
statute, again, I don't have it in front of me, but I've read it enough.
Right.
It says that a jury has the right to judge the facts and the application of the law in the case.
Right.
Not they have a right to judge the law, the application of the law. So if you pull a gun on me and say, give me all your money, and then they charge you with murder, that statute is being misapplied, so the jury would be able to say, well, that law is not applicable.
No, that's one way to interpret it, but you could also interpret that that says that they could decide to apply the law or not.
What about intending to murder? I mean, if you're pulling out a gun, You know, you could have the intent to murder, but not actually murder.
Well, sure.
Right. So there, it says nothing about having the jury be allowed to judge whether or not a law is just.
Well, it's not explicit. It's not explicitly a jury nullification statute, but the idea of jury nullification is that a jury can judge the law itself, that they can use their conscience, they can say not guilty if they believe the law is wrong. And so you could read the judging the application of the law as to say that, oh, well, I as a jury am deciding to not apply this law in this case, even though the person was indeed selling marijuana and all the evidence shows that I'm not going to apply the law. But that, again, everybody's interpretation of law is different, and ultimately, legally, the only one that matters is the one that the Supreme Court justices make, and they basically batted that one back in our faces. And in addition, said that even if a jury nullification statute is passed that is explicitly for jury nullification, that they might overturn that as unconstitutional, which I suspect they would follow through on that particular threat.
Yes.
And so while I don't oppose the state representatives passing a new law, which hasn't happened yet, but in theory, if they did pass an actual jury nullification explicit statute, and if it were somehow magically signed by the governor and passed by the Senate, then, you know, I wouldn't oppose that. But at the same time, I would also expect at some point it's going to be challenged and again overturned, which is why you suggested that there should be a constitutional amendment.
Yes.
To make it constitutional, and which would be an amazing feat, of course.
Because would require 3/5 of both houses and then 2/3 of the voters when it appears on the ballot for adoption.
So the Twitter lawsuit, let's jump in here. You've been scraping to talk about this quite a bit, and we haven't done it yet.
Yeah, so this story is from a couple of weeks ago. The Justice Department is asking a federal court to dismiss a lawsuit filed by Twitter that claims the social media company's First Amendment rights are being violated. Twitter filed the lawsuit after it was blocked from publishing transparency reports with exact details on the number of government orders it receives to turn over customer information. The DOJ earlier this month in court filing.
How could Twitter possibly publish anything about the government in 140 characters or less? I mean, everything is so. I mean, government stuff is so long. It would be really frustrating to read that.
That they were not trying to publish a series of tweets.
Oh, okay.
A lot of big companies like Apple and Google and Twitter will put out what they call transparency reports.
Like on a blog or something?
On a blog.
Okay.
Oh.
That will specify or attempt to specify how many of these national security letters or FISA court orders that they receive.
Letter. A national security letter is a letter that threatens you with federal, basically, arrest and prosecution.
Right.
If you inform anyone that you've been contacted, and usually they demand some sort of documentation that is, you know, supposed to be held in secret.
Right. So the DOJ earlier this month filed in court denying that its nondisclosure policy violates the First Amendment, maintaining it must balance transparency with national security concerns. The filing says, quote, "The additional material that Twitter seeks to publish is information that the government has judged is properly protected classified national security information, the disclosure of which would risk serious harm to national security." The department also asked the court to dismiss a number of other aspects of Twitter's complaint before taking up the First Amendment issues. The social media company announced in October that it would sue the Justice Department. Twitter maintains that its First Amendment rights were being violated because of its inability to publish the number of orders received and what types of legal processes have not been received. So what it means by that is Twitter was trying to say, we have not received any of the following. And the U.S. government said, you can't say that. They also wanted to give an exact number for the things that they have received.
Right, not details about what they received.
Don't just telling us Twitter.
Numbers. Like, you know, 205
in a year.
Of these in a year. Or zero of these in a year.
And they say you can't do that either.
They say you can't do that.
Wow,
you have to give
ridiculous.
It in broad ranges, 0 to 500.
Yeah.
There's a little bit more to this story.
Sure, let's talk about it here in a moment.
Oh my gosh.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And there's more Free Talk Live on the way. Plus, we'll sneak in an update on the Ross Ulbricht case, which continued yesterday in Manhattan. It's Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-467-5090. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-467-5090. That's 1-800-467-5090. Call 1-800-467-5090.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And don't forget, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features we have waiting for you. And also another great site to check out, freedomsphoenix.com. You can uncover the secrets and expose the lies every day at readers of freedomsphoenix.com. Get the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. They offer up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to freedomsphoenix.com, sign up for their free daily dispatch. That's freedomsphoenix.com. And we continue here. Daryl, you were telling us about a Twitter lawsuit against, was it the Justice Department?
Yes.
And now a Justice Department has filed a motion to dismiss the lawsuit, saying that the information that Twitter wants to release, and this is what Twitter is suing to release this information, Twitter would like to release the number of contacts it has received from the Justice Department that are like hidden secretive letters.
Right, national security letters, FISA court orders, and other sorts of things along those lines.
And they're saying, the Justice Department is saying, if you even release the number, let's say it's 250 in a year. This is how many they receive. Maybe it's 2,000. I don't know. But whatever that number is, they're saying that information could threaten national security.
Yes.
How in the world would that threaten security?
And even by saying zero, if the number is zero, by saying zero, that also threatens national security.
Presumably it wouldn't be zero.
You have to give broad swaths of numbers.
They're going
to
allow a broad swath, but they don't want a specific
That there was range. An agreement with Google and I believe Microsoft and several other large companies and the Department of Justice last year. Twitter was not part of that. And what was decided was large swaths of numbers are okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you can say between 0 and 500. You can say between 500 and 1,000. You can say over 1,000. But you cannot say 279. You cannot say 0. You cannot say 1.
Because terrorism. Terrorism.
Because, you know, Al-Qaeda won't blow up the White House if they don't know the exact number or something.
It's crazy. What do you think?
Because knowing the exact number is totally a matter of that.
Yeah, so
what else do we need to know about?
It says here that the government restricts companies from disclosing the exact number of national security letters and FISA court orders given to them. The letters allow agents to obtain records about people's phone, internet, and financial activity without a court order. And that's very important. So basically, you have these federal agents that write up their own warrants. And they're never, you know, given even the semblance of a check and balance.
Right. And you can't tell anyone about it when you get
these letters.
At least
with an arrest warrant or a search warrant, the police officer writes it up, goes over to the court,
and
the judge, you know, looks it over and stamps it. So at least there's, you know, the illusion of a check.
Of a process, yeah.
But here, there's not even the illusion of a process.
And this has been going on for years. I mean, this program was put into place after 9/11, right?
Right. The FISA court has existed since the 70s.
But these secretive letters
were
relatively new,
but the national security letters came about after September 11th, 2001, as part of it was actually after October 23rd, 2001, when the USA Patriot Act went in. The vast majority of the letters place a gag order on the companies handing over the information, which prevents them from disclosing details of what they are forced to hand over to the federal government. The government and a number of tech companies, not including Twitter, came to an agreement last year that allowed them to publish transparency reports with broad ranges.
Mm-hmm.
The agreement does not allow companies to disclose the exact number received, even if the number is zero. So you can't say zero. You have to include zero in that large swath of 0 to 500. There was a similar case in October that had a hearing before the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals with two unnamed companies. The ruling on that has yet to be released.
So I'm sure you will keep us in the loop as the case develops. And, of course, you can follow Daryl's work more closely by going to his website, two sites, fpp.cc, where you write stuff down, essays, editorials, news posts, And then also fppradio.com, where you are heard 7 days a week doing a newscast.
Yes.
And then also you've got Peace, Love, Liberty Radio, which you do 3 times a week. And that's a half-hour-long podcast.
Yes, half-hour-long podcast. And every Wednesday I do an Ask Me Anything, where I answer audience questions. Any questions.
How does one submit to that question process?
You can either tweet me at Daryl W. Perry on Twitter, use hashtag AMA so that I know that you want the question for the Ask Me Anything.
Got it.
Or you can email AMA@fppradio.com.
Super. News from Manhattan. Andy Greenberg at Wired Magazine reporting. This is the Silk Road case. You may have heard about this underground black marketplace that was infamous for a number of years. Finally was taken offline by the feds. Then another one popped up, and that one was taken down a year
later.
And another one popped up.
And just keep multiplying.
Yeah, and now there's other things that aren't the Silk Road. There's not just Silk Roads. There's the Agro Marketplace. There's Evolution. There's another dozen of them that I don't know about.
There's the NXT free market that we had talked about.
Are there drugs being sold on that now?
I don't know.
Because when I logged on there was precious few listings.
But you also logged on like the first day that it went online.
Good point.
And one thing that's interesting about that is that it's a plug-in to the NXT client, so it's not on a central server.
Yeah, right.
So if you take out one guy's computer or one guy's server, you're not taking down that website.
So if anyone believes that Bitcoin is magically anonymous internet money, says Greenberg at Wired, the U.S. government just offered what may be the clearest demonstration yet that it's not. A former federal agent has shown in a courtroom that he traced hundreds of thousands of Bitcoins from the Silk Road anonymous marketplace for drugs directly to the personal computer of Ross Ulbricht, the 30-year-old accused of running that contraband bazaar. In Ulbricht's trial on Thursday, there was no trial today, it was Thursday in the rest of the week, former FBI Special Agent Il-Juan Yum described how he traced 3,760 Bitcoin transactions over 12 months, ending in late August of 2013 from servers seized in the Silk Road investigation to Ross Ulbricht's Samsung 700Z laptop, which the FBI seized at the time of his arrest in October of that year. In all, he followed more than 700,000 bitcoins along the public ledger of bitcoin transactions known as the blockchain, from the marketplace to what seemed to be Ulbricht's personal wallets. Based on exchange rates at the time of each transaction, Yum calculated the transferred coins were worth a total of $13.4 million U.S. You mean direct one-to-one transfers, says Prosecutor Timothy Howard? Yes, direct one-to-one transfers, Yum responded. Now, I'm not really sure what that means, a one-to-one transfer. Does that mean that he just sent it to himself or something?
Right. So if I send money to you, then you can look on the blockchain and see that it went from my Bitcoin wallet to yours with no intermediary.
I see.
So it wasn't using one of these coin mixing things.
Yeah.
Or, sending it to, two or three other people before sending it.
Yum's testimony represents another damning line of evidence connecting Ulbricht to the Silk Road, on top of a journal detailing the Silk Road's creation found on his laptop, and testimony from a college friend who said Ulbricht confessed creating the site to him. Ulbricht's defense also confessed on the first day that he created the site, so that wasn't news.
Right, so the question here is not whether or not Ross Ulbricht created the site. It's not whether or not Ross Ulbricht was arrested in October of 2013 with his laptop on the Silk Road site. The question is whether or not Ross Ulbricht ran the Silk Road between the date that he created it and all the way through the date he was arrested.
So if what they're showing here is legit, these 3,760 Bitcoin transactions over 12 months, that suggests that maybe he was still running the
Silk Road. Not really.
Really? We'll come back with that. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the fully formed Jury Association at FIJA.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The human body is extraordinary. Despite all the stresses we inflict upon it, it still works hard to stay in balance. Thousands upon thousands of people rely upon Heart and Body Extract to help their body stay balanced. This excellent 100% natural herbal formula helps maintain healthy blood pressure levels, cleans arteries, promotes good circulation, balances cholesterol, and more. HB Extract, paired with healthy lifestyle choices like good nutrition and exercise, can give you a life free of pain, sickness, and fear. Recapture your youthful vitality and experience your body healing itself with the aid of HB Extract. It's extremely effective and it starts working in just days. Visit HBExtract.com to learn more and to read scores of testimonials from satisfied customers. And we've never increased our price in over 10 years. That makes Heart and Body Extract as great a value now as it was the first day we sold it. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Call 866-295-5305 or go to HBExtract.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.fm Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. Enough time for you if you dial now. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, the New Hampshire Liberty Forum. It is going to be here before you know it. And Free Talk Live is going to be in attendance. We're going to be broadcasting every single night. Daryl, I know you're going to be there. Danica, do you have plans to attend the Liberty Forum this
year? Yes, I love Liberty Forum.
It's an awesome event. So you go to nhlibertyforum.com. You can learn more. There's a schedule. It's already being filled out. I don't think it's complete, but they're starting to add a lot of stuff to it. March 5th through the 8th. And it's a great excuse to come up and visit New Hampshire. Check out this amazing movement, the Free State Project, moving liberty-loving people to New Hampshire. Well, the Free State Project doesn't move you here. You just have to agree to move here and then figure out how to do it on your own, because these are a bunch of self-starters. These are entrepreneurial types. These are liberty activists. They're libertarians. They're voluntarists, anarchists. And they come together, hundreds of them, in the Radisson Hotel for the first time. It's usually in Nashua. It was previously in Nashua, New Hampshire for many years. It has moved this year to Manchester, which I think was a good move. They needed to have a larger hotel space. We were outgrowing the old hotel. And the old hotel was a decently sized hotel. So they're moving to the largest hotel in New Hampshire, which is great. The largest convention space in New Hampshire. So it doesn't get much bigger than this.
And it's right by the airport, too.
Yes. So you won't have to rent a car or anything like that to actually, you know, if you're going to fly into the airport, you don't actually have to rent a car or take a long cab ride to get to the hotel. So it's easy access. Manchester, of course, the biggest city, the most restaurants and amenities and things like that. Plus, I was told about a special offer today that is going to be something I've never heard them do before. So I'm shocked by this. I think it's a pretty good deal. You, if you purchase your hotel room for all 3 nights of Liberty Forum, so it starts on a Thursday, it ends on a Sunday, so Thursday, Friday, Saturday night, if you reserve a hotel room for all 3 nights and use code LF, as in Liberty Forum, LF2015 when you reserve the room, then email me, ian@freetalklive.com, with your name. They will give you a ticket for free. You get a basic ticket to the Liberty Forum for free.
Really?
So
don't you need something more than just a name to be able to confirm that they
Well, I'll have your email address if you're emailing me. So they've asked me to provide your name and email address.
Okay, so you don't need like a reservation confirmation number?
Well, I guess
can we use a code?
I guess presumably you should give me the same name that is used to reserve the room.
What about Liberty Movement Ruiner? Like, is that the code to
No, there's no code. No, you just have to email me. The code you want is LF2015. That's what you need to reserve the room. So if you get 3 nights at the Radisson in Manchester during Liberty Forum, which is March 5th through the 8th, if you haven't gotten your tickets yet, you get those 3 nights reserved. You email me, ian@freetalklive.com, with your name that you want on the ticket and presumably the same name that's on the room reservation. They'll check it. They'll verify you've reserved the room, and they'll lock a ticket in for you, which is pretty cool.
Liberty Nice. Forum is just, it's so fun because, I mean, obviously it's shorter than Porkfest, but you get to dress up. I mean, you don't have to dress up, but it's strongly recommended.
It's a little fancier.
It's a little fancier. And, you know, most of the goers like have an excuse to dress up. And, you know, not like Porkfest where you're not out in the hot, you know, the hot sunshine and you have a hotel room with showers that you can frequent often. I mean, it's a nice contrast from Porkfest. Not trying to put anything bad on Porkfest. It's just, it's a nice different way of getting to meet people and going to different conferences. That's not like camping.
Although the ever stylish Jeffrey Tucker still wears his bow tie during Porkfest.
Porkfest
is, by the way, the yearly event that the Free State Project puts on in the summertime in a campground, and the Liberty Forum is a yearly event the Free State Project puts on in the wintertime in a hotel. So go to nhlibertyforum.com to learn more about that. As we go to Perry in Nashua, New Hampshire, listening to WSMN. Hello, Perry.
Hey, there you are. Cool beans.
Hey, Perry. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Cool beans. WSMN had a hockey game. I couldn't hear your show.
Oh, no.
What were you talking about? I couldn't hear your show. I listen to your show every night.
Oh, thank you, Perry. I'm so glad that you're out there dedicated listening to Free Talk Live. Unfortunately, one of the crosses we have to bear as being a nighttime show in radio land is that some of our radio affiliates will put on local sports. And whenever that happens, we usually get the bump.
Hockey. I don't do hockey.
I don't either. Hockey. I don't either. It's not my choice. It's not my decision. What I'd recommend, I know you said you don't have the internet, so you're kind of SOL.
The listen lines.
Yeah, you could call our listen lines, which I don't have in front of me right now. So, oh, actually, I do have them here, but I don't really want to give out a bunch of phone numbers over the air.
What have you been talking about all night?
Well, that's a good question, Perry. We've been on for over 2.5 hours at this point, so we've covered a few different things. The Twitter lawsuit against the feds. Big chunk of the show was spent on itinerant vendors, people going door-to-door selling things, sort of scamming people. and offering to shovel snow and being threatened by the police and all of that. But we'll look forward to hearing from you another night, Perry, when you've actually been listening to the show. And I thank you for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Another option for people who don't have the internet but want to listen to Free Talk Live and don't get us consistently enough on your local talk station is you can go ahead and get a free-to-air satellite system. As long as you have a view of the southern sky at your home, you can get a cheap dish and receiver and point that dish at our satellite, and then you can listen to LRN.FM's content, as well as which includes Free Talk Live when we're live. And that's free. Once you pay for the dish and receiver, there's no monthly subscription fee. So back to the Ulbricht trial. Daryl, you said that Ross Ulbricht receiving 3,760 Bitcoin transactions over a year, ending in late August of 2013. Now, remember, he had said that he wasn't involved in the site after the beginning and was somehow reeled back in to serve as the fall guy when it was taken down. Well, when he says he was getting reeled back in, it doesn't sound like that was a 12-month-long reeling in. So what's your explanation for why he's receiving 3,000-plus Bitcoin transactions over a year? So 700,000 Bitcoins.
Just because Ross Ulbricht, on the day that he was arrested, had control of a Bitcoin wallet does not mean that he had control of the Bitcoin wallet the entire time that that wallet was in existence.
That's true.
Absolutely.
Because there's such a thing as a private key for a Bitcoin wallet. I could, right now, Ian, I could give you private keys to some of my Bitcoin wallets.
But it's unlikely you would do that.
That would not mean, right, but if I'm, you know, transferring a business.
Yeah.
You know, it's a whole lot easier for the customers to just have the same address that things go to. So it would be a lot simpler for me to give you the private key to a Bitcoin wallet, and then you become the owner of that wallet. That does not mean that you received all of the transactions that happened before I gave you control. It just means that
wallet...
But
if all the Bitcoins are still in the wallet, then you wouldn't be doing that. Like, if the 700,000 Bitcoins were in your private, in your wallet, you sure as hell wouldn't just give someone that private key.
Right. But it doesn't say how much of that money left the wallet. They only talk about how much went into the wallet.
That's true. And nor does it mean that he was running the site. So it could mean that he was receiving residuals. You know, maybe his deal with the whoever it was that took over the site was, yeah, I don't want to run the site anymore, but you can cut me 5% of the total revenue.
There's a lot of big companies that when they wind up selling, there's some sort of residuals.
Right.
All right, I don't have enough money to buy this off of you up front now, but I'll keep giving you 10% of profits or whatever,
which
is agreed upon.
Yeah, which would be a smart move. I mean, if you know the Silk Road's going to keep growing and all that. So we'll find out more about what the explanation for this was, but this obviously is not looking good for Ross, right? Yet more evidence. The case against him seems very, very strong, but to be fair, the defense has yet to actually call their first witness. So we're still waiting on that. But what was pointing out here is that, let's see, more broadly, the testimony of the federal government's expert confirms what most savvy Bitcoin users already know, that the cryptocurrency is by no means untraceable or anonymous by default. Although using Bitcoins doesn't necessarily require revealing any identifying information, all Bitcoin transactions are traced on the blockchain. And that's the same widely distributed list of transactions designed to make counterfeiting Bitcoins impossible. If someone can identify a user's Bitcoin address, in Ulbricht's case, by seizing his laptop that he was using at the moment of his arrest, then they can often be used to trace his or her transactions. In fact, Berkeley computer science researcher Nicholas Weaver had already shown that he was able to follow more than 29,000 Bitcoins from the Silk Road to Ulbricht's laptop based only on publicly available information. The prosecution, which did have access to Ulbricht's hard drive, had far more success. Nearly 500,000 of the 700,000-plus Bitcoins were transferred from September to November of 2012, explaining their relatively low total exchange rate. Remarkably, the total trail of drug-tainted coins represents more than four times as many Bitcoins from Silk Road Ulbricht's laptop than have yet been found and seized in the Silk Road investigation. It is not clear from Yum's testimony where the rest of them ended up. So yeah, some of them are still out there. And they also brought up the murder for hire allegations at the very end of the day on Thursday, but the bulk of those will be saved presumably for Monday. We'll keep you in the loop. We'll see you tomorrow. FreeTalkLive.com.
Negotiation isn't just something union leaders and sports agents do. Your entire day is a series of negotiations. If you have young children, you know that. In fact, your kids can teach you a lot about negotiating with grown-ups. According to the world's greatest negotiator, Herb Cohen, author of You Can Negotiate Anything. Herb says that kids understand the process of decision-making within an organization. When one parent says no, they'll ask the other. And Cohen says children persist and persevere. And like smart negotiators of all ages, kids know that no is an opening bargaining position. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, January 30th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.95 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,262 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports one day after unveiling plans for a record military budget that once again totally ignored sequestration and other spending caps, President Obama is now calling for Congress to do away with sequestration altogether. Obama is planning to unveil a new budget on Monday, and it is expected to include massive spending increases across the board, insisting the spending is necessary to help American families succeed. The reality, of course, is that the President and Congress have been basically ignoring sequestration since the idea was initially proposed, and the only time it comes up is when the Pentagon, which is constantly being exempted from it, continues to hype it in their quest for new record budgets. In the end, officials seem to have gotten the best of both worlds out of sequestration, ignoring the mandated cuts while it is in place and then looking for even bigger spending hikes afterwards to make up for cuts that never happened. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Wired reports a former federal agent has shown in a courtroom that he traced hundreds of thousands of Bitcoin from the Silk Road Anonymous marketplace directly to the personal computer of Ross Ulbricht. In Ulbricht's trial on Thursday, former FBI agent Iluam Yum described how he traced 3,700